Welcome to the Fatty and Tubbs Hour. I'm here with my boy, CK.
By the way, which have we ever decided who's Fatty and who's Tubbs?
I'm Fatty, you're Tubbs.
All right.
My self-esteem, my self-esteem is a little lower than yours, I think. Like,
I feel sorry for you, brother.
Well, at the time, my self-esteem was lower, so I still think I should be Fatty. Plus, I can play like a near diabetic detective. I think a little better than you.
Plus, I can play mine off and say I'm the dude from Miami Vice.
I like it.
It's not because I'm fat. It's because I'm black and I wear 80s sports coats.
Except you're the furthest. But that's the thing. Like, you should play a black character.
Oh, yeah.
But, like, no one notices that you're completely white.
Yeah. I have a melanin problem.
Sickle cell. So not only are you morbidly obese, but, like, sickle cell.
Yeah. I'm the one white, half, partially black guy with sickle cell.
That'd be awesome.
You ever wonder why blacks get sickle cell?
I think it's because they're, I don't know.
Like, they gave us AIDS, but we, like,
yeah,
they can't give us that for some reason.
Now we're going to walk the line of the racism. Because
no, I mean, well,
monkeys,
that's how, yeah, because it's in the jungles of Africa or whatever.
But the black people are not the monkeys.
No, but they're the ones that fuck the monkey.
Okay, okay.
Oh, and it's not like you're African Americans. It's
by
like,
by the way, what a dick to be
tribesmen.
Like, what a dick to be like, let's fuck that monkey.
Yeah.
And that monkey's like, ooh.
You must not have a lot of options over there. It's like,
but right before, they're like, man, all these women in the village, you know, no one's ever caught anything. But have you ever fucked a monkey?
Yeah, and none of them have shirts on. Like, all you're doing is looking at titties all day, and you still have the urge to fuck a monkey.
One real thing that I did find out is that, like, during the Super Bowl,
mm-hmm.
they print off, like, 10,000 t-shirts of each team.
Oh, yeah.
And then they mail them off to like, the Philippines and, like, all these little African countries.
There's three villages in Africa with Buffalo Bills Super Bowl shirts.
That is, and then you see pictures and you're like, what? And you look at them, they're like, but they're happy because they have a shirt now.
Yeah, Jim Kelly, he's my hero.
The Patriots have sent a lot of different teams,
mm-hmm.
team shirts. During.
They really wanted those Tom Brady shirts.
They're like, oh my, like, what if they're watching it? And they're like, they're Seattle.
I'm just throwing this out there. This mm-hmm. could be wrong. But I think if they're waiting on clothing from the Super Bowl, they're probably not watching it.
What are you talking about? They got, like, direct. What if they had direct TV, but they couldn't get, like,
anything else? That pisses
me
off. I don't have cable. If they have cable and a free shirt, then that really sucks.
You got Netflix.
Mm, yeah, but I have to pay for it. They get the shirts for free.
Oh, man. Yeah.
And they got a 48-inch plasma TV in the middle, of, like, stuck to a Adobe out in the middle of the jungle.
What if there was, like, the one guy that just everyone was pissed off at the village, and his goal, like, his job, his whole life was to hold that satellite.
Yeah.
Like, during, like, peak hours.
Probably so. They probably rotate it to whoever was, like, the biggest dick that week.
Hold it closer. I need to watch Mike and Mindy. By the way, I don't know why there's Russians.
Yeah.
It's hard in Africa.
To do a, like,
without being like,
You either go Russian or you go Indian. I mean, there's really only two
Indian
accents.
Exactly. But there's so many Indians out there. It's like, it's kind of nuts.
I always wondered why there's no white tribes. Like, just in the middle of Africa. Like, just not one. Like, they all moved to South Africa to get diamonds. Like, not one of them got left behind and had to start a tribe.
You know what?
That.
I bet the conquistadors were like, they took the white ones and they're like, hey. There are other white people over here, and they're like, oh, man, this is awesome. And then just started getting sick and dying.
Yeah.
What? The one thing that I think is that I saw that was, I thought, really funny was The Onion had one, and it was Native Americans give amnesty to 4 billion white people, undocumented white people. I'm like, that's right. They were here before us. So there you go.
Yep. You ever see Louis C.K. when he was talking about Indian givers?
Mm-mm.
Like how that term came, if you give somebody something and then you change your mind and take it back. Like, that's what we're our idea of how we got this country is. Like, they gave it to us and they got mad, so we had to slaughter them. And you're like, you guys are Indian givers.
That is the best, because they didn't even know what, like, owning stuff was. They're like, hey, we're all working together. and we came in and just gave them diseases.
Yeah, they gave us corn, and we slaughtered them.
That is weird about, like, Thanksgiving and stuff, how it's like, oh, man, everyone's holding hands, when really it was, like, this unspoken anger and then people dying.
Well, that's what my Thanksgivings were like growing up. So I think we held true to the tradition. A lot of uncomfortable anger, not being really expressed in a good way.
Firsthand. Okay, so, hey, you open this door. I'm going there. So, as we're about to go, we're in the car, and he's like, hey, guys, just to let you know, my whore of a grandmother is going to be there. And I'm like, so I'm just picturing this old lady with her legs spread, like, oh, another guy, bring on the cock. And I open the door, and a normal grandmother meets me and goes, oh, hi, how are you? And then I look at King, and I'm like mouthing the words, whore? I'm
like, yeah, she's whore. A fucking whore. Fuck that bitch.
It was awesome. But then there was just the, yeah, Thanksgiving.
Yeah, they were always weird. It was usually just me and my brother and my dad.
Yeah,
in the other room watching football.
Uh huh.
While everybody else pretended to like each other.
Yeah. Did your
was staring
your
mom- at the clock, wondering when the hell we can go home, and then waiting, thinking, oh, I don't have to see those people for another year. It's really good.
And then, like, your the best part was you were like, I think one of my cousins is gonna be there. And then I was like, you don't know you had a cousin? I'm like, eh.
Yeah, there was the one I didn't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, I found out about her when she was, like, 20.
Yeah.
I didn't really know.
Well, you know, and you took a lot of time to get to know her.
I did.
Saying, oh, hey.
I did.
Hey, that's how you go. Was your mom allowed to leave the kitchen?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
She's like, get out of the kitchen.
They usually, the fights usually went to other rooms in the house.
Oh, okay.
Like, it wasn't, like, the food was never right. That's what to this day, my dad has never had a meal he's enjoyed, I don't think.
Ever.
Ever. Everything's undercooked, overcooked. This isn't right, that's not right. He's just an asshole. Sorry, I got a burp.
Didn't really register.
That's good.
But it's on there.
That's good. It registered with me.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just don't think, I don't know. The guy, there's just no pleasing him.
Yeah.
And it's starting to, like, I'm starting to recognize that in me.
Yeah.
I'm like, God, I hope I'm not that guy. He's like, the fucking gravy's too runny.
Well, I made you dinner, and you didn't, like, complain at all about it, so I'm cool.
No, if Lisa would have made
but
it.
But I would take on that abuse, like, that abused, like, spouse-type deal, where I'm like, oh, I'm really sorry.
You'd be the one apologizing to the kids later because of the drama, because you had to see him throw the recliner across the room.
By the way, I know in our household, if we were together, there would be no throwing of recliners. They'd just be sitting in it angrily.
Yeah. At most, we'd look at it and think, I should throw that, and then it's like, or I could sit in it and play video games.
Yeah, that would be the thing where we just end up playing video games angrily, if you can do that.
Oh, you can do it. I do it all the time.
You can do it consistently? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Consistently?
Oh, yeah. I harbor, like, just pure, like, just a ball of fire of hatred that...
The hate diamond. You press all your
that's
hate
why
further down.
It gets so hot, I have to cool it off with alcohol.
Yeah.
And that's really...
Which brings me to the condition...
That's really where the ARS came
exactly,
from.
Exactly, which brings me to the condition of ARS, alcohol rage syndrome.
Mm-hmm. Alcohol rage syndrome. I believe I'm the only documented case.
Okay. There are, but you're saying there's more undocumented cases.
Oh, yeah. People have it, and they go untreated for years.
For years.
Those are the ones that shoot up schools and go to work and shoot their boss because they didn't get a raise. Like, if they just go home and pour liquor on their pain and their anger, they would go away for a while.
Yeah.
You know, and, I mean, it always comes back the next day, but...
Does it manifestate in any physical condition, like anything physical? Does it manifest physically?
No, not really. I mean, it's more of a brain, more of a neurological symptom.
Okay.
I mean, it can. If you don't treat it for a while, you'll punch a picture frame here and there.
Picture frame. Glass picture
you'll
frame.
You'll kick something that fell on your way. But for the most part, you just deal with it
like
mentally.
Like a small child. Another person's child.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, that's why they're there. Just soccer kick.
Yeah, if it's a, especially as a boy.
But if you're in public, I mean, the alcohol. Yeah. Now, okay,
they frown upon that. Okay,
in public, where does it can ARS rear its ugly head?
If you've poured a lot of beer on it and it's so powerful that its symptoms are still showing, then it might take over your speech pattern and maybe make you say things to people you probably wouldn't say normally.
Yeah.
But your brain's still functioning well enough to know if that dude's going to kick your ass or not.
Gotcha.
So you don't just randomly spout it out. If you find like an old drunk guy that you know, if he came over, I could punch him and he'd go down. Then yeah, it might manifest itself into a verbal symptom.
Okay. What about the emotions? What emotions go through ARS?
Oh, you know, it just depends. Sometimes, some days it's just pure rage until you drink till you're numb. Other days it's more
physically numb or just emotionally
physically.
Numb? Physically.
Yeah, physically.
I feel that that's the way you should.
You really don't go emotionally numb because even when you're laying in bed and you can't feel your legs, you're still like, oh, this sucks. I'm going to feel like crap tomorrow.
You didn't go, and then there's the disappointment in the ARS that you didn't fulfill your ARS symptoms.
Correct? Right, because every day you think, tonight I'm gonna handle it. You know, symptoms are going to come up. I'm going to read a book. I'm going to go to bed early. Yeah. That'll fix it. And then you, next thing you know, you've been home for 20 minutes and you've already had a beer and you're like, I guess I need some medicine tonight. And it goes just, yeah.
So, but you're not going to like a pharmacy to get that? Or do you mix it with prescription drugs?
If you're lucky enough to get prescription drugs, you should absolutely mix them.
Now, I don't picture a lot of like lit rooms full of flowers when you have alcohol rage.
No, you usually keep the farthest light that you can see on.
Okay.
And that's just so when you get up to pee, you have some sort of reference.
Gotcha.
So you're not bumping into Legos and shit.
Yeah.
You keep that on so you can tell where the bathroom is and eventually make the journey upstairs to call it a night and say, tonight I've won the battle
of ARS. You've curbed the ARS. Mm-hmm. Now, can you, I'll do it. I was going to have you explain when you came across, when we were trying to figure out what condition you had. Mm-hmm. I was working and I get a call and it had been like maybe an hour or two since I had seen my boy over here. And you know what? Let's just call it the ARS podcast. I like it. It sucks that I'm going to have to keep buying you alcohol. You completely smashed.
Podcast would be a little more boring if I was just drinking coffee.
The first five would be awesome, but by that sixth one, you're just like, God. And then it just turns into just like my body.
I'm actually really excited to see where this goes after about seven or eight of these.
Okay.
I don't know.
The podcast?
The podcast.
Oh, okay.
I'm more worried that it's just going to turn into a pornographic, like, just shit fest, like when every time we hung out together.
I think this will kind of keep us focused a little bit, but what's wrong with
that?
Well,
I know you've got a computer. I don't know what you're looking at over there.
Pornography's wrong.
Okay? It is wrong. I respect the woman's body.
And by the way, that was not the worst thing we, like, not that we ever did talked about it, but best gore? There's so many good stories.
Oh, I can't go there anymore.
No, the point is we shouldn't have gone there in the first place.
No, because I went there in some dark times. And there's things that I'll never unsee.
No, you can't. Mm. No.
And I've seen more suicides than any human on this planet should ever see. And I think at first it made it worse, but I think now it actually helps.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, I see that you think it's going to be this easy way out, and it's not.
It doesn't. No.
No, it looks. Somebody's going to find you.
Yeah.
Now, that's my biggest fear.
Yeah.
Is if I were to. And granted, I'm not in that. I'm not there right now. I'm not in that mode where I'm going home thinking about it. But it's always in the back of your mind once you've been there.
I think that's people.
Mm-hmm. But honestly, the thing I learned from going to these doctors and stuff is that it doesn't just affect you. It affects. Because I always think, who's going to find me, you know? Like, if I don't show up for work for a couple days, somebody's going to come looking, and somebody's going to find me. And somebody's going to have to live with that vision in their head the rest of their mind.
Well, and then the thing is, too, all those gases might build up in your body, and they'd have to take, like, a spear and, like make it so they could get you through the door.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then, like, the whole apartment complex is going to smell like Chipotle for, like, a week.
Chipotle. By the way, Chipotle
formaldehyde.
Stock, Chipotle stocks plummet. We enter a recession. But okay.
So anyway,
okay,
best score.
But
best
no.
Score.
But which is interesting because the only reason we found that was you were telling me about this serial killer in the Canadian guy, right?
Yeah, that was like the Canadian ice pick killer or some shit.
Yeah, where he cut up his boyfriend, and then. So
he cut three limbs off, and then he fucked him, his stump, after he cut his head off.
Yeah, like, well,
and then
he
used his hand, his arm, to masturbate.
Yeah. Well, the weird thing was, so I see it, and we watch like 3 minutes, and the guy looks creepy, you know, almost like that Buffalo Bill in Silence of the Lambs. We're like, oh, that's crazy. Mm-hmm. And that was like Tuesday. So I was like, I got to work in the morning, man. I'll see you. He's like, oh, okay, cool, man. The next day, come into work, and I go, oh, man, you didn't watch the rest of that, did you? You're like, yeah, I watched the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh, it was an hour. It was like an hour and 30 minutes.
Nah, it was short, and I fast-forwarded like every 30 seconds.
I was going to get to that where you were like, oh, you didn't watch. Like, I'm thinking you're just watching like,
no,
oh, man, what's happening next?
That, like, I wish I could go back and unsee everything I've seen on there, but even then, like, nothing grosses me out. So it wasn't like I was disgusted by the act. It was more disgusted by how a person's brain can be so fucked up that they think that's normal.
Yeah.
So that's the part that I can't... you know, to me, it doesn't look any different than when you're watching a gory movie.
Yeah.
But you know the gory movie's fake, and you know this is real, and that's what creeps you out. The people like that walk the streets every day.
Yeah. And they look like weird emo... gay guys.
But with this guy, you didn't get the sense that nobody knew something was wrong with him. He was pretty fucking weird.
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
Yeah, and then, like, there was a bunch of other stuff this guy did, like PETA was after him and all this. And by the way, you don't mess with PETA.
No.
They're more likely to chop your body up and fuck you than a serial killer.
Yeah, if you hit a dog, PETA will be up in your ass.
That brings me to another great thing. So, I was watching TV, and that Sarah McLachlan...
That's weird. Continue.
Okay, bestgore.com. I've gone through sections of it.
Yeah, have you ever? You ought to go on there and check out the sexual ones. Pretty fucked up.
Yeah, I bet. Ugh. I can only imagine.
Like, gee, I wonder what a man's dick split in half looks like.
So I was watching Chopped, which brings me to the next story. I was just watching Chopped, and they did that Sarah McLachlan commercial, and I was telling King, I was like, I can't watch it, man. They're trying to upset me by playing In the Arms of the Angels behind it. And, dude, you had the best response to it, which was, do you remember it?
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead, tell me.
It was about the song, right?
Yeah, the song.
The song is what makes it sad. Because, like, really, you look at a dog has the same look on his face all the time. If you just took away his food... You're going to think, oh, he looks sad. If he has that same look when you just gave him a treat, you're going to think, oh, he's so happy. But really, he's a dog. He has a dog face. They don't smile. They don't frown. They don't cry. They're just dogs.
Stop being an asshole dog.
Yeah. They just have the face. Uh-huh. Unless it's like a pit bull, like wanting to rip your nuts off. You can tell when they're angry. But you can't see sad or happy. Maybe by their tail. But you don't know because they don't show the tails. They just show the face and put a slow, horribly depressing song there.
They're probably wondering, dude, why do you have this camera in my... Well, open the door, let me out, and adopt me.
Yeah, I'm thinking if they played... I believe our example was Milkshake.
But it was Baja Men who let the dogs out. No, it was Milkshake.
Yeah.
It was Milkshake.
My Milkshake brings all the boys to the yard. I felt like if you played that same song over it... People would just be like, oh, I fucking love this commercial. Look how cute those dogs
are.
They
were like, I love that
song. They would. They'd
the
be like, this
were skyrocketed.
These dogs are so happy. They're so they had happy. Somebody gave them a milkshake and people came and visited them. It's awesome.
I do love your stance on, like, I don't think you're for animal cruelty.
No, not at all.
I kind of want to start a campaign that you are. For animal cruelty, and how you've kind of like people put like a human fit like they're animals.
Yeah, they're
now
animals.
Should they be? attacked and hurt? No, I don't think. I don't think anything should be attacked.
No, I, it's the same way I feel about hunting. I don't understand it. I don't like.
You never go hunting?
No. No, it just seems weird to me.
What, like, if you had to?
I mean, if I was, like, the zombie apocalypse happened and I had to kill a deer, I'd kill a deer. Yeah. I still don't think I could eat it. I still think I'd starve.
You'd kill it.
Unless I had a foreman. Like, I still couldn't see myself just eating raw meat.
The cannibals find you, and they're like, "You're like, how'd you find me? I was hitting so well." And they're like, "Well, we saw the
there's an 100-foot extension cord going in that house over there. We'd smell Montreal steak seasoning."
And we're raiding your stash of pizza rolls and steakums.
I just
is there anything better than a steakum?
Not really.
Okay, now
pizza, I just can't see, like, hunting is a sport to me. That's We have the debate on what's a sport and what's not a sport. Hunting is not a sport. That's
it's a sporting.
Dudes that went into Columbine were hunting. That's the same thing as to me. That's the same thing as going in the forest and just killing as many deer as you can. I mean, it's they don't know what's
okay,
coming.
Hold on, the deer weren't in a school. Okay, I think you put those deer in a school.
Well, they're gonna freak out, first of all. Then you have to kill them, because then they're going to knock shit over, and then you have to kill the deer. But you've taken them out of their element.
But if you play, like, a Bon Jovi song, "It's a Beautiful Day," you'd be okay, right?
Oh, yeah, it's absolutely fine.
I think you should play that "It's a Beautiful Day" song on probably every video we've ever watched.
I always picture it like the, like, early settlers, like, they had to hunt. They had to catch their food.
Yeah.
And they had to fish and eat the fish. Uh-huh. And then at some point, somebody finally opened up, like, a place they could go to get food.
Yeah.
And the people are so twisted, they're like, you know what?
It was a Denny's.
They got it probably was a Denny's or a McDonald's. Like, man, that McRib was really good, but goddamn, I'd love killing stuff. So they just continued to kill stuff. Like, then you don't even eat it. You just take its head and you mount it on your wall and you think, remember when I killed that thing? That was awesome. But you can't do that. It's... Like, the same people, you can't have one. You can't have both, okay? You can't have...
Let's not transfer this over to humans where you're like, "Do you remember when I killed that one?" Well,
that's where I'm going, you know? People see, when they got mad about Michael Vick, and they're like, "How could you treat an animal that way?" But you could walk into somebody's house and see the deer head, and you don't think twice. You know, that's what always... You can't have one or the other. It's got to be both ways.
Well, okay, I think if there's the person that has the deer head and, like, the buffalo skin rug and stuff, and goes... Can't treat those dogs that way. You shot something with a high-powered rifle. I understand that.
Right.
Now, people we know and other people that, you know, have beds made for their dogs, it's like, I understand why they could be like, because that's, they emotionally attach to that, thinking, I have dogs, I would never want them
alone. Oh, absolutely. And I, you know, I'm not a dog person, but I understand pets, except for mine. Mine's an asshole.
You're the cat?
Yeah, he's an
the
asshole.
Cat that you got, and we're like, "Oh, that's awesome! You got a cat."
I got it for my daughter. I don't like it.
No,
it keeps to itself when she's not there.
Well, let's just say you haven't made it the warmest environment in the world.
Probably, that's probably fair to say.
Yeah.
Is
it sad that the only other living thing in your place
feels shunned? He sits in the corner,
the
just
alcohol rage.
Man, I'd really like to sit on his lap, but he hits me every time. So we
or
just stop trying.
Just like, God, open the door, leave me alone, asshole. Like, you're walking by and you both like, you're like, "Oh, hey, stupid cat, what are you doing, you asshole?" And then the cat's like, "You motherfucker."
Yeah, he does. I guarantee he looks at me like that when I'm sleeping. It's like, this is the shittiest home I've ever had. Like, he wants to be on Sarah McLachlan's commercial, so somebody else can adopt him.
Do you think he's like he's sleeping and then he hears like the CPAP machine go on?
Oh, I think it's soothing to him now.
Soothing to
him. It is. It's a soothing noise.
Unless it's like Guantanamo Bay and they're playing like Master of Puppets.
Yeah. Yeah, he's getting waterboarded at night just to go to bed.
Yeah.
Here's my thing with the dog. And you know this because I've talked to you about this.
Yeah.
You can be mad that somebody does that shit to dogs because it's not right.
Mm-hmm.
You can't be more mad that happens than people abducting children and killing children. You can't be more mad.
No, I don't think you can.
But I think the outrage that was sparked with Michael Vick, if Adrian Peterson would have killed one of his kids, he'd just go to jail and people would stop talking about it.
Well, he's black, so he's automatically... going to go to jail.
Right, right. And they're probably not his kids.
Well, they probably are.
Well, no, some of them are, but not the ones that live in his house.
No.
No, he doesn't know his real ones.
No.
He just mails a check to somebody.
Mails a check.
I just don't think you can be... The anger just shouldn't be the same to me. That's just my feeling.
Not the anger, but the outrage.
The outrage, yeah, the outrage. Okay. The anger, yeah, be mad. Yeah. People hate Michael Vick. That's fine. He's an asshole. But everybody knows that.
To be honest, I'm gonna play devil's advocate here. Michael Vick killed those dogs, electrocuted them. Adrian Peterson just hit his kid.
Yeah, and I don't think...
The kid's still alive.
I agree. I'm saying if he would have killed him. Like Leonard Little. Oh, okay, Leonard Little that played for the Rams got drunk and killed a guy.
Yeah.
He was suspended for like 6 months.
Well, I mean...
He didn't go to jail.
Technically, had he done it on the field, it would have been a 15-yard penalty.
Yeah, that's true.
Just
that's true.
Unnecessary roughness.
It is. And it's, yeah, you've taken it like he led with his helmet. You can't do that. The refs are going to call it every time.
Well, I mean, you got to hide it. You know what I mean?
Right.
And it definitely would have been more of a black eye if it was like in the, you know, third or fourth quarter.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. That's right.
It's a close game.
That's right, bitch.
You can't kill somebody in a close game. You just cost us 15 yards.
You can't. You can't make that up.
But he's not the first one. There's been other people that have gotten drunk and killed people.
Yeah.
And the outrage just wasn't there. Yeah. That's the part that bothers me. I'm all for if I had a dog and had that connection with a dog, and I heard about that, I'd say, fuck Michael Vick, he needs to go to jail. And he did. And it worked out for him. I mean, he paid his price. He came back. People still hate him, and that's fine. Everybody's going to hate him forever. But he at least paid the price, came back, and he's been a pretty good citizen ever since he came back.
What I don't understand is why would, like, he get out, and you're like, oh, you know, he gets his deals back and stuff, which is whatever. But then he's, like, getting a dog.
Yeah, that part.
Why would you do that?
If he wanted to get a dog, get a dog, but don't make it public, you know? Well, that's just kind of like spitting in the face of all the people that got mad.
Exactly, because it's like, you know, like, that's what people are waiting for you to do. Like, they're at pet stores. Like,
mm-hmm. Yeah, people are, around. There's like paparazzi outside his fence, like watching him toss a tennis ball, like, just drop it in the wrong place once, dog. Just see what happens.
Exactly.
But, you know, he's not going to do that because he probably actually loves his dog. And I think I've told you this, too. Honestly, a black person growing up in the South, that's what they do.
If anyone would know.
Yeah, I've got a lot of street cred in Atlanta.
Yeah.
Down in Georgia.
Georgia.
I've been to Freaknik about six times.
Diana.
But that's what they do. That's how they're brought up, you know, to them. Really, I honestly don't think he thought he was doing anything wrong.
The whitest person in the world. He's like, you know, black people. All
what is the deal with
teens,
these black people and their dog fighting?
When they turn 13, they get a pit bull.
Mm-hmm.
They're directed towards their local pit.
Their uncle teaches them how to dog fight him. Not their dad. Their dad's in jail or not around.
It's not around because they're in jail.
Uncle Pete, which is actually his mom's brother.
There you go. I feel bad for all the uncles.
Yeah, because they got to raise all everybody else's kids. You have a sister and you're black in the South, you're like automatically, like, I'm going to have to raise her kids one day. Fuck.
They have the best 401ks in the world.
Yeah, they got to be responsible and save their money. She's still dancing her way through college.
Hey, I hear Atlanta has the best strip clubs.
That's what I've heard.
Yeah. You're never a big strip club.
Nah, no? I don't really get into them.
No.
No, I have internet.
Just hardcore.
Yeah, I just need penetration.
Hold on, this is gonna go over the internet. Not describe, but clarify what kind of penetrate, like men and women.
Oh yeah,
okay,
like, yeah, like penile vagina.
Okay, there you go. Well, that sounds really weird in that face.
Penile and vagina.
The next one might have to be a vidcast because the face you made when you say penile. Sounds like it would be in one of those dirty films.
Yeah, every time I went, I got bored in like 5 minutes. And all the other dudes are like, yeah, this is awesome, throwing 20s out. And I'm like, eh, I'm not really feeling it.
You know how many beers I could buy?
Oh, I know.
You did?
And they require you to keep buying drinks. And it's just, it gets expensive just to see some titties.
Yeah.
I can do that for free at home.
When you can see a Japanese newscaster in a kiddie pool.
I've always wondered why they blur out their penises. So it's just a blurry block of jizz coming out of nowhere.
That's, yeah, that's not... Like,
they're okay with the jizz.
I would almost prefer the woman's face getting blurred out, because she looks so uncomfortable.
Yeah. Her parents know who it is, but they don't know where that jizz is coming from. Oh, blurry ball of jizz shooting on daughter's face.
And don't you love that it well, okay, this is like, oh, now I'm warming up. Here we go. But when it blurs out like half the screen, you're like, dude, you're Japanese.
Yeah, it's not that big.
I'm not, yeah. No. It's you know, and it's like just pressed up. And then like half the time she's delivering the news, why it's pressed up against her face.
And that's impressive that they could still do that.
And she still has the composure of that dick. Like, and the guy looks not upset, but he looks like they're focused.
And you know what the best part is they're still more credible than Rush Limbaugh. Like, they're as the, more, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, their news is more significant than Bill O'Reilly.
I'm going to talk to you straight. Yeah. The Japanese newscaster with eight dudes. And it's like someone was just handing out flyers like, hey, man, come on in. And they're like, this woman's like, man, maybe I'll only get like 12 loads on me. And it's like 20 guys.
Talk about not knowing what your day's going to be like. Like, when you go into work, it's like, man, I wonder if the boss is going to be an ass today. Or it's like, how many loads of jizz am I going to get in my hair today?
And then like the dry cleaning bills. I mean, you're the company's got to pay for that, don't you think?
I would think so.
Because it's almost like annoyance.
Eventually in Japan, it's just going to be robots newscasters that they're jizzing on.
Now you're fucking talking. Now you're talking my language.
Have you seen those? They're creepy.
Robots?
The creepy ass ones that Japan, everything Japan builds is meant to be fucked. Like,
yeah.
So they keep building things like machines to fuck. And
yeah.
I don't understand how that's possible when there's like 12 billion of them.
Yeah.
They're obviously fucking something.
They're tired of fucking each other.
I guess so.
Or it would be too shameful to fuck someone else. So they're like, yeah, I'm gonna create this
robot. That guy, if he fuck women.
Now, they're actually like those real sex dolls
mm-hmm.
are like 12 grand. Or
yeah, 20. They're not cheap. I've looked into Amazon. It. You can get a used one, I've heard.
Okay, what kind would you get?
You know, I've never really thought about it because they're so creepy looking in the face.
Yeah.
Like, not that the chicks I brought home, I look at their face either. But
why?
But at the same time, I at least want to know. I don't want them to haunt my dreams. Like, the other ones I can block out with my ARS medicine.
Christmas.
But I feel like if I fucked a robot, I'd have to live with that the rest of my life. Like that might shame, that might be etched on my grave.
Oh, it's like, being buried with you. I yeah, know that.
That's true. If I paid 12 grand, I'm that motherfucker's coming with
by
me.
By the way, it's going to be an open casket, and you're going to be hold. I'm going
to. Oh yeah, I'm going to cuddle.
Yeah,
we're going to be a nice romantic.
Yeah, you're not going to be buried with like a rosary or prayer cards. Mm-hmm. It's going to be your fuck doll.
Actually, I find it. I doubt there's going to be an open casket because I don't think they'll let me in a church to be buried. Like, it'll just be in your backyard.
It's going to be in a funeral.
You know, you're going to have to dig the hole yourself and put me in it.
Oh my god!
And like, somehow, your dogs are going to come out and shit on me all the time, especially Gus. Gus. It's like, yeah, I heard about that Gus mask, motherfucker.
Well, the best part is, like, I'm such a procrastinator that you'd just be back there for weeks.
I'd be decayed. The neighbors are calling the police. Sir, why is there a decayed body under your backyard? I just haven't got around to it yet. Here's the paperwork. I'm supposed to bury him. I just haven't done it.
The paperwork. I'd probably even lose the paper. It'd be in my car.
Like, the coroner just gives you a document to take home. Like, if the cops ask, here's the paperwork that says I turned him over to you so you can bury him.
Honda. I just like, put the seat down. Get the seat down. Put him back in the, like, a flat screen TV.
Get in the fucking carpool lane with me. Just leave me in the passenger side.
Weekend at Bernie's.
Till eventually I look like the crypt keeper. Then you have to bury me because Lisa's yelling about the smell.
Things are going to be getting at you. You'd probably be feeding all the neighborhood. The cats.
Yeah.
The cats and
squirrels. Cats don't play around. You die, they'll eat your face.
Oh, they don't.
See, that is one thing about dogs. Dogs are more loyal. You read those stories about vets coming home and the dog sees them, or the guy dies in the house and the dog lays there by the butt. Cats, they'll eat your shit, right? You don't have food for them the next day, they will start eating you.
I do remember something depressing you did say to me, which they're going to start coming to me the more I talk to you.
Right.
That I was like, oh, man.
I bring that out
in
people.
I love my dogs. You know, they're like, you know, I just, they understand me, and you looked at me, and you went, you ignorant motherfucker. They're animals. He goes, if you were to die right now, which with my anxiety the way it is, I probably shouldn't be bringing up these thoughts, but if I die, if you were to die right now, they'd wait a little bit till they got hungry, and then they'd start to eat you. And then I think you took your snack and went into the living room to watch TV.
My pickled sausage, and I just went in there and just ate while knowing in the back of my mind I just affected your entire life.
Yeah, like, well, and now I'm looking at my dogs and I'm resenting them because these motherfuckers are going
to
eat me.
Yeah, you're so just staring at them like, I have to go outside. Yeah, wag your tail, motherfucker. I know what you're doing. You're just waiting for me to die.
They're waiting for me, like they watch me eat my food and they're like, oh, that's gonna be delicious. Watch that go to your
clog those arteries. The sooner the better.
Speaking of that, can you tell me one of the ingredients in a pickled sausage?
Of course, we all know this. It's mechanically separated chicken.
All I picture is like a chicken, like, you know, chickens are stupid. And it's like there, and it may not have a beak like they do in like those food documentaries when they're like, they cut off their beak so they don't kill each other. I would, you know, if you put 30 of them in a cage, they're probably going to try to kill each other.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
But there's just like, oh, hey, I'm you know, I'm on the catwalk. You know, it's like going through this conveyor belt, and this fucking machine just full of fucking blades just comes down and just like mechanically separates the chicken.
2,000 chickens just got mechanically separated at one time.
Separated. How awesome would that
be? And like the majority of it, like 90% of it goes into lunch meat. And then there's that one, just like one Mexican guy at the side, just like putting it into like a
Jorge,
like literally, it's a milk crate with a trash bag in it, and he's just scooping it. And he's like, "This is what we're gonna use to make pickled sausage."
He takes one of those ash stokers, the ones where you know you clean out fireplaces with, yeah. And just he does it there, and then they go.
They continue on through the plant, and they go through the, like the place where they put the chemicals and the preservatives and all. His just goes into the trunk of his car, and he drives it to the place that makes pickled sausage, which is like a 4-hour drive.
Oh yeah,
it's in Mexico City because that's the only city that could actually make pickled sausage.
Well, because the health regulations are so low, they're more worried about cartels and shit.
Oh yeah, he actually walks over like 40 mass graves to get to the pickled sausage plant.
I picture that slow ride, take it easy, in a hatchback with just the sun blaring down.
And he's hitting bumps and shit, and it's just like just swishing around in this milk crate sack.
That's actually a good swishing sound.
I practice a lot. And then there you have it. You just put some hot sauce on it. You leave it out until it solidifies.
What form does it describe to the people that are the three people that will listen to this and realize that their lives are pretty awesome? What shape it comes in?
It looks like a hot dog, but less healthy than a hot dog, if you can believe that. Like, there's more health standards that go into a hot dog than a pickled sausage.
Yeah, well, there's more animals that go into a hot dog.
Right, right. There's a lot more preservatives to keep the various animals alive so that the hot dog can take its penis shape and maintain it. They have to tie off the ends, and they get that cute little almost anus-looking end on them. Everything about a hot dog is disgusting. But a pickled sausage is like that, but unhealthy and tastes way worse.
I love that you would go to like a QT or like... That convenience store that's weirdly owned by Indians, hard to believe. And you're like, oh, I wonder how long that hot dog's been out there. That's gross. Mm-hmm. I'm going to get this prepackaged. They can't call it meat.
No, it's not meat. There's no meat in it. It's
no mechanically separated chicken.
It's chicken shit and Tabasco sauce. It's pretty much like just formed. I think they mix it with the stuff they make Jell-O.
Okay.
Just to get it to stay in one shape.
Cow hooves. So they're taking the cow hooves too.
Right.
The gelatin.
Right. And then you just shove that in your mouth and shit for 3 days. It's an awesome time.
Now, when you're eating it, I already know the answer to this because I lived with this for a while. You feel good eating it.
No part of you feels good.
You keep going, this is a bad decision, but you have to eat it all, right?
At that point, you've challenged yourself mentally to eat the pickled sausage.
Now, can you tell me what kind of juice? Like, you know, like
it's probably
pickled,
like,
so
it's pickled and I don't even know how to describe the taste. It's a little, I don't know. It probably tastes like like an old Mexican lady's vaginal squirt.
Okay.
Like there's a little spiciness to it because she's Mexican.
Okay. I don't mind the explanation, but the blatant racism. Oh, like, Latinos, they're spicy.
Well, she's surrounded by peppers.
Because
chili.
Tabasco. Mexican women's squirt paste like, picante
like,
sauce.
Like if there was an elderly Mexican woman, she still
squirts. Like, I love that. Like somehow you've come up with the ultimate fantasy for this poor Mexican woman. That she's like, oh my god, I'm so turned on. And it's just a fountain down there.
Oh yeah, like that guy just drops off the milk crate with the bag, and she has to masturbate into it in order for me to have a snack.
Do you think he gets tired? He's like, Consuela, hurry up.
Yeah, because she's old and her stamina's built up over the years.
Oh, just calloused.
Like, she has to probably, like, yeah, it's not a pretty sight.
By the way, if you think about it, that's a pretty good job.
It would be a good job to get paid to just squirt on a pile of chicken meat.
Mechanically separated.
Mechanically separated chicken meat.
Which is completely different. Because to me, it seems more horrifying.
Oh, yeah.
Because I want to know what machine does that kind of work.
Yeah, that can only have one use. It's not a multi-use machine.
Yeah, it's not something that's used by good people.
By the way, who do I have to suck off to get a beer around here?
Well, you can get up and get one.
I can. I didn't know if I was allowed to leave the area.
Keep going and talking about old Mexican women's vaginas, and I will go get you one.
Oh, go ahead and bring me two. I might have to be alone for this. Can you step out of the room? I'm going to think of Consuela.
Oh, hey, Poppy.
I bet when you're old, that old, you don't call anybody Poppy anymore.
I think you're probably at the stage you are with sex now. Like, it's almost just too much work.
Yeah, it really is. The last couple times I've had sex, it really was just taxing. I just didn't enjoy it. My back hurt. I had to pause halfway through and catch my breath. It's
so
when you
were like 18,
just
banging chicks,
pile driving.
You're like, oh man, when I'm 30, just imagine when I'm in my 30s. Oh, just come everywhere.
I'd have never thought when I was 37 it would, like, I'd have to prepare myself for it, stretch out, and you know, like,
you don't want to cramp.
Yeah.
Have you ever cramped up?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, it sucks.
Really?
Like a foot cramp. Never, like, in my legs or anything. I've had foot cramps during it, and you have to stop.
Have you worked through it, though? Like, have you powered
you try.
Through it? You try?
You try, but eventually you got to be like, I got to stop. This is, hold on a second. And you got to take care of it. You got to stretch your foot out. It's not, it doesn't ruin the mood at all.
No.
Really, no.
The crying kind of during it does. Right.
You know the worst part about sex is when animals get in the way. Like, a dog will come lick your feet while you're trying to, throws your concentration way off.
Yeah.
Every time I've had to smack a cat off a bed while I'm trying to have sex, that's just annoying.
So like, but like twice.
Yeah. Or when the people on the train tell you to stop. It's just like
the seeing eye.
Mind your business.
Have you ever been with a blind chick?
No, I have not been with a blind chick.
Or a deaf one?
No, I have not been with a deaf one.
So you never had the Helen Keller?
No, I bet I've had some that were borderline retarded.
Okay, because they made the choice to have sex
right.
with you, or like
clearly, I'm not a great decision on their part, so they must be
okay,
retarded.
Just because people make poor decisions. There are people that make poor decisions all the time.
Yeah, but if you take even like 10 minutes to get to know, like if you listen to 5 minutes of this podcast. Mm-hmm. And then had sex with me, you're retarded.
Okay, by the way, I'm not having sex with you. And
so he says, the night is young, my friend.
I mean, let's see. Let's just, for a minute, forget that I'm me, one of your friends, and I'm a chick. Mechanically separated chicken.
Mm-hmm.
Best gore. Well, shit, I probably would have sex with you.
That's true. Yeah, if those
Japanese
are your alternatives.
Newcasters.
Maybe that's what I got to do. Maybe I got to turn my apartment into more of an evil place, to where like they get there and they immediately feel like they need to run to the bedroom for comfort because I have like Like, it looks like a corpse that I've been meaning to bury.
Like a Dexter.
Yeah, there's plastic up and like utensils sitting out on the table. And they're like, oh shit, and now the door's locked. They can't get out. So they have to like take refuge in the bedroom.
Yeah.
And then I immediately switch on and there's like, I'm like wearing a leisure suit, smoking a cigar on a stick.
Now that's hot.
Yeah.
Now we might be talking.
They completely forgot about all the hell that was downstairs. And they just say, fine, if you're not going to kill me, then I'll let you have sex with me.
This is the alternative. So their imminent death is either downstairs or the worst.
The worst thing they could do that year is upstairs.
For an hour.
So they'll easily take that over imminent death.
But what if there was the one that...
By the way, can this be used as evidence in court?
I don't think so.
Can I sign a waiver?
No.
All right.
By the way, all your friends are here, and we actually... I knew this was the only way I could get you over, so we're going to talk to you about some problems.
It's going to turn into an intervention. Danielle, come on up.
I wrote something, and I just want you to hear it.
Oh, sweet Christ.
So, but that would be the equivalent of like swiping right. Like we.
Oh, yeah. In real life, if you could do that in real life. Like, I had to face them and they just like pulled out their phone and swiped right while I was standing right in front of them. That would be the ultimate shame. Just like.
By the way, you could sell that. All right.
I guess I'll go.
They make you leave your own apartment.
Yeah. Awesome. Yeah, I have to leave. They swiped right. I have to get out of their life forever.
I'll be back before
can you just
Best Buy closes.
Maybe shoot me an email when you leave so I can come home.
An email. Can you IM me? Facebook?
I'm on AOL Messenger.
We were talking about MySpace.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of miss MySpace.
I miss MySpace. I miss the Remember when they put out those like questionnaires that I would fill out?
God, you had some good
I really
stuff.
Liked those.
Good. You had and the best part the thing I love about you is you're almost off the grid for the fact that every year you change phones with different companies. So the best part is you're like, "Oh, I looked at my old phone and I found this and I found that and this was written on here and I saved this PDF file, you know." And you had like a Palm Pilot. I'm pretty sure everything's on your Palm Pilot.
Now a Palm Pilot is just me imagining that I'm fucking an actual pilot. That's my
now,
Palm Pilot now.
Would you?
I guess it depends on how old he is.
Oh, I was going to say a female.
Because we're not going
to... It had to be a dude.
Yeah, we're not letting females fly planes. Well, that's not going to happen.
Okay, let me ask this. You get on a plane and there's a female pilot. What do you do?
Well, at least you know she's not a terrorist.
Well, there you go.
You're not going to fly into a building.
Lights a building
because they wouldn't let her on there without her thingy.
Without her thingy.
Her what?
Without her thingy.
Her thing. Isn't that what they call it?
Yeah, they call it a thingy.
And Muhammad told him to wear their thingy.
Durga thingy. Yeah, that's what they're doing.
That's what I thought they were called.
Here we go with racist time, making fun of people's cultures. We've already insulted the blacks and Latinos.
Yeah, we'll pretty much run the gamut before it's over.
Yeah, and the thing is, plenty more podcasts to do.
And you know, and the thing is, I just like the jokes. You know me, I like the racist jokes. But I'm not a racist. I actually hate racist people.
Uh-huh.
Hate them. Mm. We had a lady in the store. We had to kick out. Yeah. She was legitimately coming in the store, and if a black person came up to her and just said, "Can I help you find everything? Or are you finding everything okay?" She'd say, "I'm good," and he'd walk away. Okay. She'd immediately find a manager and say, "That man over there is harassing me. He won't leave me alone. He's following me around the store." She's done this for 4 years now.
Yeah.
At our store and the KC2 one.
Uh-huh.
So we finally set her up. And I didn't know there was a setup, but Danielle and Lindsay, one of our other assistants, found a kid in produce who happened to be black. He's a lighter skinned black kid.
Well, almost mulatto.
Well, I believe he's from Puerto Rico.
So
but
he's not black.
Well, no, he's black. I think he had his dad was black and his mom was Puerto Rican or something. Shit like that. I don't know.
Might as well be black.
Yeah,
at least this woman called the other guy a man.
Right.
It wasn't like that animal.
Well,
over
no,
there.
He's called him. She's called him like that kid, and it'll be like a 25-year-old dude. And
maybe the guy was acting like a kid.
So we had him go up to her, and Danielle and Lindsay were watching the whole thing.
Uh-huh.
And she comes up and he says, "Can I help you find anything today, ma'am?" And she says, "No, I'm good." And he walks away. That was the whole thing. She immediately goes to the meat department, pages the manager. Well, she didn't page the manager. She had somebody page me. So I get out there, and she rips my ass. Says that she's being followed around the store. She's being stalked. The guy won't leave her alone. She's in a hurry. She just wants to go home. She doesn't have time to be bothered by this. So we finally just say, fuck it. We catch her in the liquor store. We went over there. She's complaining to the checker over there about it. So we basically said, you know what, lady, just don't come back. You know, and my exact words were, you're trying to get good kids in trouble for things they didn't do.
Yeah.
So go fuck yourself. Well, except for that part.
Done,
I didn't really say.
Hadn't done yet.
Yeah, maybe. But I mean, maybe so. but the truth is,
somehow I just turned into Blaine Lively. Are you sure? Did you witness the whole conversation?
Yeah. Why did you put that Klan hat on, John?
You're gonna believe
the white man over the unidentified coloreds.
This unidentified black male who could have had a gun at some time was torturing this poor woman by asking her, harassing her.
So that's what I never understand is people like that, you know. If it were me, I would come up and be like, hey, here's the deal. I'm going down every aisle, and everyone keeps asking me if I need something. This is more annoying than it is making me feel uncomfortable. You know what I mean? Like, this is just, it's just fucking sucks. I don't need to be being asked if, like, that's almost, I could say, not even really legitimate, but that's a nitpicking thing.
Mm-hmm.
But to just be like, oh, you know, that, you know, like, if it's a consistent thing.
Yeah, it's, you know, always, I mean? It's always black people. Always. Yeah. And she did it at Casey too. I have an assistant named Dom that's a black guy, and he used to work at Casey too.
Was a black guy?
What's that?
Sorry, in my mind I was like, he was a black guy.
He was. He used to be. He's not now.
Well, this woman turned him white.
And he was running the front, and she called and said that he followed her out to her car. Hmm. Well, he was running the front end, he never left the store.
See, that's definitely wrong.
So we kicked her out, and she called corporate. She called the cops on us that night.
For being anti-racist?
Right. For accusing her of being a racist. And her exact words, this is how you know you're a racist, when you say, I work with a lot of black people.
Yeah.
You're a racist. If you have to justify your feelings on it, you're a racist.
But the thing is, maybe those black people never follow her around or ask her anything.
That's true. She's just never because they're not working.
Well, she works at the unemployment office.
That's true.
Racist.
But see, that's the thing. The jokes are funny. The reality is not.
No, it's not.
The reality is not. Just like homophobic, I will make fun of gay people all day long, but I think if you're homophobic, you're a fucking douchebag.
Oh, yeah, for real. I mean, the name of our podcast is Fatty and Tubbs.
Yeah. We know who we are. We'll make fun of fat people, but look at us. We're not spelt.
Hey, okay, hold on now. Now this is where it starts getting hurtful, and now I start realizing that when you make fun of people and you point out things, that it kind of hurts feelings.
I'm
so,
sorry.
So
I didn't
watch your fucking mouth.
I didn't mean to call you fatty.
Okay, Tubbs. Well, it was weird because I was gonna say something before you talked about the story, that when you got out of your car, I saw that like this white kind of sheet came out.
Mm-hmm.
It almost looked like a ghost costume.
Yeah, it's for Halloween.
There was a couple 2x4s in there too.
Yeah.
So,
do you have any lighter fluid?
I do.
I'm all out.
Are you?
Yeah.
What do you need it for? It's getting a little warmer.
I'm gonna have a campfire.
Campfire
this weekend.
Nice.
With some friends.
With some friends
from down south.
From Georgia. How do you say Georgia?
The Boot Hill.
The
Boot Hill, Missouri.
Missouri. I do love that. I do love that. Blatant racism. Like, come on.
Gays are
getting married now.
It's 2015. Come on. Why are we still racist? Like, you know, honestly, I think a lot of it is once my dad's generation is dead.
The baby boomers.
I personally think racism will be better, but I'm not black. I don't walk in their shoes. You know, I don't know.
My politically incorrect mind was like, racism will get better. Like more.
Like we'll be able to do it more. Like, yeah, this is awesome.
It's like that scene.
I just dropped the N word on that guy. This is sweet.
It's like that end scene at the end of The Wiz, where like all the black people come out and they're like, shit. It's like, let the racism begin. More racism. No, like.
And it's same with homophobia. I think. I don't know. I don't understand. I think homophobia actually bothers me more than racism. Because I can see racism, you're brought up a certain way, and your parents tell you, your parents use the N-word or whatever, and but homophobia is like your choice. Like, you see a gay guy and you hate him because he's gay.
Yeah.
That's your own choice. Yeah. That's just stupid.
Well, because that's the thing.
Why do you care what he does?
Well, the thing is, being gay...
Or she does.
Well, the thing is, being gay, you can be any color.
Right.
Like, and that's the thing where, oh, they can choose, they're choosing that. Well, it's like, you really can't choose to be black. I mean, you're born black.
Mm.
So I think I would think most likely die before, like, homophobia, because it's, and the thing is, too, it's like, why does it matter? If someone's happy, let them be happy. You know what I mean?
The only ones I have a problem with are bisexuals.
Okay, because they're greedy?
They are. They're very greedy. Like, pick a hole and fuck it. Don't take everybody's opportunities away.
Well, exactly.
There's somebody like me out here that could use something to put my penis in, and it's being taken up by a bisexual.
Because there's a rampant rage of bisexuals.
Yeah, they're just walking the streets, and they're just fucking our women and men, not even giving me a chance to fuck either one.
What if you were in the store and you were like, this bisexual came up to me and did not want to have sex with me?
Oh, could you imagine? It'd feel like twice as bad. Like, he doesn't...
Swipe me.
She doesn't want to fuck me, and she doesn't want me... She doesn't want to scissor me either. Like...
Yeah. Would you have banged this racist chick?
Oh, fuck no. She's disgusting. She's white trash.
Just because of the racism? Well, what if she was
no,
a 10?
No, she definitely looked trashy. She definitely...
But what if she was a 10? What if she was Mia Kunis?
No.
Really?
That shit bothers me. No, that's how much that shit pisses me off.
Okay.
I don't hate it. You can be dumb, and I can deal with that. Okay. You can even be ugly, and I can work around that.
Work around that. Okay.
But if you're an asshole, I can't deal with an asshole.
No.
Like, if... Granted, nobody's going to understand this, but if Gold Minivan was a racist, she wouldn't have come over the second time.
Really?
Yeah.
Even on, like, the A scale. Like, an A scale... No. What about, where are you on the A scale? Can I ask that, where you're at the A scale?
I'm about a negative 65.
Negative 60.
Yeah, if somebody texted me that I didn't know about, to me that would feel the same as an orgasm at this point. I'd be like, oh my God, I haven't talked to her in so long. This is great.
What's up?
Yeah, exactly. But then they come over and they want to have sex, and I'm like, this is going to hurt. My back.
It's gonna hurt. What if you bought you know what would really stop that? Is if you bought like
a Vietnamese fuck swing.
That would actually facilitate it. But I have a feeling you'd get caught in it, and then we'd be like, oh, where's King?
Yeah, I'd have to call you and be like, hey, I'm stuck in my swing.
No, the thing is, like, but you can't get to a phone. And so, like, your close friends were like, oh, let's all go together. And we hear...
And you're immediately like, he hung himself. That
and we're like, oh, who's
going to
go up there? And it's even worse. You're up there, but you've passed out because you were upside down.
And I haven't had food in 6 hours.
And there's a pickled sausage still in its package. That would be awesome. And it's bad to be negative on the A scale, right?
It's very bad. Yeah, when you're negative on the A scale, that means you're... If you like reach negative 100, you've given up.
Just
like I am actually 90% asexual now. Did this get weird for some reason?
No, sorry. In my mind, and then the asexual hit.
Yeah.
And then it just got like, oh no.
I can't actually impregnate myself. So technically, it's not asexual.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm just not interested in that right now. I assume if I find somebody I like, it'll change. But right now, I'd rather just go on a date, make out, and then jerk off when you leave.
Not even can the person be like, she's like, oh, I'm gonna go unless you want. You're like, oh, well, you can stay. But
no, I mean, if she wants to, I guess I'll do it for her. Just so that she'll text me again one day.
Do you think it's like the equivalent of you putting together like IKEA furniture? Like, it's just gonna be it's a fucking chore.
Yeah, it is. It's like
parts.
It's like she might as well say the fucking harvest is ready for picking. Need to go out there and bring.
Hold on, did we get racist again? Hold on. Because you're almost turning.
It's like
into
I gotta
like a
strap that. I gotta strap that little wooden fucking sled and go up and down and cut the
wheat and shit. I don't know. It's just, to me, it's not worth it. I'd rather just go home and have a sandwich.
But then you realize, you're like, fuck, I gotta make the sandwich.
Yeah.
Do you realize that a lot of the stuff you have to do just takes your time and your effort?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and my time is so, it's too busy dealing with this ARS to focus on this
ARS
stuff.
The ARS. Well, can I ask you, you said reading books.
Yeah.
You read any good books lately? Or just like a chapter and then you're like...
No, I actually I actually went on a stretch where I stopped drinking and I was reading every night, and I read... I actually went back and read A Time to Kill by John Grisham.
Racism.
Well, actually, the only reason I read it is because he has a new book out that's actually the sequel to that. Mm-hmm. And I never read the first one, so I wanted to read that.
Really?
So,
like a prequel.
Which, it's funny, because you know the movie, A Time to Kill. You've probably
Matthew
seen
McConaughey.
That. The
Samuel
big,
Jackson, the black guy that's in everything.
Right. Like, the big part of that movie is when Samuel Jackson's on the stand, and they're asking him questions, and they're grilling him, and they say, did you kill him? And he says, yes, I killed him. And or no, they said to you, are you glad they're dead? And he said, yeah, I'm glad they're dead, and I hope they burn in hell. In the book, he doesn't even testify.
Yeah.
So that was pretty disappointing. Like, that's the... I was leading up to that, and then he didn't take the stand.
Oh, yeah?
So that's why sometimes...
That kind of sucks.
Yeah, it was disappointing. But it's a good book. And he has the new one's called Sycamore Row. I wanted to read that.
Yeah.
So then I started drinking again, and I haven't started Sycamore Row.
Well, there you go. You could have saved yourself. You could have drank while you watched the movie and been like,
that's
oh, my
true.
God, Matthew McConaughey. I want
I
him as my lawyer.
I could have squeezed 2 months into 2 hours.
So shouldn't... Okay. Maybe I'm getting a little crazy here. But shouldn't they just call it Time to Kill... To Kill a Mockingbird Part 2?
I don't know. I've never actually seen To Kill a Mockingbird.
You haven't?
Uh-uh.
Oh, you might be
I'm missing out
ISIS,
on a lot of
shit.
There's a lot of stuff that I wish I'd seen. I have like a Clockwork Orange. Never seen
it. I don't
know.
I don't know if you'd like it.
I always feel like it's just... I just should watch it.
Dude,
it's just something you need to watch.
Dude, okay, so that movie Eyes Wide Shut?
Mm-hmm.
I watched that.
I didn't like it.
You know what? I kind of dug it for the fact that it's kind of this journey. I didn't like Tom Cruise or even Nicole Kidman in it. But the story was kind of interesting how it was like don't get me wrong, like everyone at that time was like, oh, it should be NC-17 and there's all this stuff. And it's like everyone had masks on. I mean, I've seen worse on that Game of Thrones. You know?
Oh, yeah. And have you seen that show Girls on HBO?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's...
But they only show funky titties on there. They don't show really good titties.
I never saw that. The only part I saw was a clip where some dude licks a chick's ass while she's doing dishes.
Oh, okay.
And I thought...
Well, that's probably from the hot raunchy. Chick. Oh, there you go. Well, it was
I've never
like,
seen it, but I just thought, that's pretty raunchy. That should be porn.
In The Wire, the mayor gets his dick sucked, and you see there's this...
That big old giant black schlong. Yeah.
And they're talking about this movie. Now, I thought the movie was interesting, but I thought it was a really weak premise. And I think Clockwork Orange is kind of the same, too.
Mm-hmm.
But it's, I mean, the visuals are good if you watch it from, like, a visual standpoint. Because I watched The Shining.
Mm-hmm.
That's another Kubrick film.
I've never seen that one either.
It's not that great.
Really?
I mean, if you watch it for the fact that you just want to watch the scenery and stuff, it's good because he's a great filmmaker. The stories just never seem to be behind anything.
And I think technology ruins a lot of that, too. Because it's hard to watch some of those older films now based on what you're used to seeing. And the acting, like the acting just doesn't seem as good back then, which is kind of weird.
Yeah. But by the way, whatever happened to Kurt Russell? I watched him in Escape from L.A. By the way, horrible movie.
Yeah.
But he was awesome as Snake Plissken. He should only play Snake Plissken or...
He's actually working at a chicken plant in Mexico.
Mechanically separated
collecting
chicken.
Consuela's jizz.
He's the jizz collector.
Yeah, that's what he's doing
That
now.
Should be his movie, The Jizz Collector.
The
female jizz collector. You know. So let me ask you this. This is completely kind of off subject, but movie-wise. Best Denzel Washington role?
Best Denzel Washington role. My personal favorite... is probably Fallen.
You know what? Underrated. Like, not a lot of people know that movie.
Mm-hmm.
It's a good freaking movie.
It is a good movie.
John Goodman.
You know James Gandolfini?
Gandolfini? Yeah. Dude, you can't go wrong with Gandolfini.
Yeah.
Dude, he was in Crimson... They were both in Crimson Tide.
Mm-hmm.
That was a good movie.
Yeah. Viggo Mortensen was in that. A lot of people Viggo. Forget that.
Dude, it, like, what's the deal with him showing Wang, like, his Wang in the movies and stuff?
I hope that's the last Wang fight scene I ever see.
Didn't you go to the movies? You saw that one?
Yeah, I saw it in the movies, which is rare, but that was, yeah, I saw it in the movies, so I saw his dick, like, on the big screen. It looked huge.
Huge, just flopping around. In comparison. Yeah, I would think so. Now, worst movie. Worst Denzel. And I know that's tough because...
Worst Denzel movie. Well, see, I've never... There's a couple I've never seen, so I don't know. Surprisingly, one I've never seen is Philadelphia. Never seen
that. It's about AIDS.
Yeah. I've heard it was a good movie. I've never seen it.
Yeah, but he gets AIDS.
I've never seen... Oh, I know what I'd pick. The fucking... Didn't he do the debate movie?
The Great Debaters?
Yeah.
You didn't like that?
No, I never saw it.
Oh, it's a good movie.
It just looks stupid.
You know, because you're a Southern plantation owner,
right?
And you're other.
I'm
liar.
Not gonna watch those coloreds argue. I could do that all day on the streets,
listening to their hip hop and drinking those wine coolers and their Mad Dog 2020s.
That's great drink. It's the last time I'm gonna tell you. I almost said the N-word, but I'm
yeah.
That's like the only thing I'm not going to say. I'll say anything else.
Especially not in the same compound sentence as Denzel Washington.
Right, because Denzel's, he's my nigga. Denzel is, yeah, Denzel's the shit.
There you go. Yeah, that movie, The Great Debaters, was good, but I do get, what was the football movie he was in?
Remember the Titans. Didn't like it.
I didn't like it. I definitely didn't like that one.
But, you know, I don't like sports movies.
No. Okay, so what's the best sports movie that you can kind of watch? I think you like Cobb, remember?
Cobb was good. It wasn't a great acted movie, but it was a good story.
A racist Tommy Jones? Tommy Lee Jones?
Bull Durham's a great movie.
So, okay, that one is he can't have sex and he has good games, or if he has sex, he has good games?
It's not really. He gets on a hot streak and he decides to not have sex until they lose or something to that effect.
Okay.
So, but that's not really a big part of the story. But
well, it should be, because that would make it a good fucking movie.
What's the other one? The First Major League was hilarious.
Dude, that is a good movie.
That's a classic. It goes right up there with Airplane, Naked Gun. Some of those kind of movies.
Dude, that's a saw. Okay, so give me your comedic five. So like, funny movies. Because, you know, they're like, oh, my top five. But
my favorite funny movie is, I've never met anybody else that thinks this, but my favorite comedy of all time is Me, Schindler's Myself, List. And Irene.
Not Schindler's
and
List.
And Schindler's List is second.
I like Me, Myself, and Irene. I think it's really funny.
I think
funny.
It's the funniest movie I've ever seen.
Ever seen?
Yep.
Really?
Yep. I think...
That's a bold statement.
What
made
else
here
would
on
there
Fatty
be?
And Tubbs.
Anchorman, the first Anchorman.
That is a pretty funny
pretty
movie.
Friggin' hilarious.
Yeah.
Horrible Bosses.
Horrible Bosses. Did you see the second?
I haven't seen the second one yet. Yeah. Sequels to comedies usually aren't that good for some reason. I don't know what?
Would you,
because they can't top the first one.
Now,
they just can't.
Yeah. Would you put... I like this one, and some would be like, oh, it's a chick. It's a hilarious... It's like a mockumentary. Drop Dead Gorgeous. I love that movie.
I've actually never seen that one.
You have? Mm-hmm. The da-da, da-da,
oh, I think you had me watch it once.
No, you watched it with our friends, DJ. You watched it, and it has Jesus on the cross, and she dances with Jesus.
Oh, I did. Yeah,
I
remember that.
Well, apparently it's not going to be on your list.
Yeah,
you
don't
fucking
I didn't remember it well enough,
wow.
I guess.
Wow.
I
guess that was not going to be on the list. It's Crash and Burn.
Way to go. Way to go.
Motherfucker.
You just lost... Two viewers.
I'm sure we've lost
now we're
a
down,
lot.
Now we're down to one.
By the way, we in the first 10 minutes, we lost the Latina population, which is growing in this country.
You know what I feel, though? Who I feel sorry for?
Tell me.
Your wife.
My wife.
Look at her. She's just...
She's gone.
She's not even... She left. She actually moved out while we were doing this podcast.
Are you moving in?
Let me get out of my lease, and I'm there.
That sounds good. How much to break it? just spend your bonus on it. You'll be okay.
I'm actually moving soon.
That's good.
Did I tell you that?
Yeah, you did.
I'm moving to my fourth apartment in the same building.
What if it was the same old apartment? Can you move back to the same old
apartment?
Steak fights. Explain steak fights.
Steak fights was, we lived in the second floor of a three-story building. And we used to play Rock Band, Guitar Hero. We'd rock out, our thing.
This was before I was even there. You live with multiple men.
Yeah.
Well, at different times.
Oh, let's bring up my personal life now.
You've had roommates, and there was a roommate before I lived with you.
Yeah, and we used to just chill. Mm-hmm. We both had a minor drinking problem.
Which together made a major drinking problem.
Which, you know, we were both battling ARS at the time. And
but do you ever stop battling ARS?
Not really. No, it's like HIV. You know, it's always there in the background.
You just don't get the sores.
Yeah. Well, you do, but you just...
Anyways, steak.
So there was a larger lady that lived above us and had a giant dog. And we used to hear what sounded to be wrestling. And we just imagined that she just went to the store and bought a raw steak.
Like a T-bone
or like something giant. They just tossed it on the floor and they fought for it. So that's what we called steak fights. Because that's what it sounded like was going on.
The best was, because they were still going on. When I lived with you at the time, the best part was so steak fights had another friend, Pork Chop.
Oh, I forgot about old Pork Chop. She was hitting on you.
She wanted.
Oh yeah, I forgot about old Pork Chop.
I didn't show up for like a week or two, and she looked even grosser.
Mm-hmm.
And
this is which is amazing hard to do.
Me, that I'm like, oh the. But yeah, she was something else, and I was like, oh man, there's two of them up there. So steak fights doubled. And, but what if maybe she was like studying line dancing or not? There wasn't a rhythm to anything.
Yeah, it was just chaos.
It was chaos. It was like
steak fight. Maybe she had a Snickers bar and dropped it in the couch cushions and was so angry because she needed it that bad. But other than that, I think the only scenario would be fighting the dog for steak.
She called Pork Chop over to help find it. But yeah, so I came, I think it was right before I moved in, and Pork Chop came up and told you, like, hey, who's your friend? Which is awesome, because it always feels good when even men, like, kind of hit on you, like, oh, you're kind of attractive.
Right,
it's nice to, but eventually you want someone that's like, wow, I'd really like to have a relationship with you, to say it and not be like, wow, you're great. You're a great guy.
Yeah, that's what I. That's where I'm at.
Creature worthy of.
That's where I'm at. Nobody, I leave. Nobody says, "Hey, who was your friend?" Nobody says that. They're not like, "Hey, who was that really like dickish dude that kept making fun of people, and they went home with a scowl on his face?"
Well, sometimes they do when they like have to fill the rest of the report out.
That's true. Yeah, if they're not sure, like the spelling of my name on the restraining order. Maybe they ask about me a little bit, which feels good.
They
care enough to at least ask for the restraining order. Feels good.
They're gonna get your number eventually. You know, you'll see them in court.
You never know when I don't show up. Maybe they'll feel lonely and they'll feel like I didn't think they were worthy of stalking.
That you didn't choose them.
Right, and they'll be a little sad one day. They'll be sitting there in their fucking pink sweatpants. They're not like pink. They just say pink.
Pink. They say pink.
They're like black, but they say pink.
Or juicy.
And like a t-shirt from like a 5K they walked on. Yeah, they didn't run it. And they just walked it. And then she's like, you know what? That guy never even stalked me. That's depressing. Maybe she'll Facebook me.
He didn't even kill any small animals. I'm going to leave him at my steps.
So that's my dream.
Do you ever think that like steak fights was like, I wonder if he's still alive down there? You know, like, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah,
like,
probably. Because there wasn't a lot of sound coming from my apartment unless Vile was singing.
This is true. This is true.
Unless she could hear me crying.
That was weird. Your pillow was always wet. But it wasn't like, oh, like, well, you, okay.
Don't mind the wet pillow. Consuela was here.
Okay. I remember moving you, and I go, what is the deal with this? Okay. So you know... A mattress, it reaches a certain point where it not really becomes a mattress anymore, but just like a holding of old skin and sweat.
Yeah.
Explain, okay, because I go...
My mattress was King Tut.
It was a...
yeah.
It looked like it was made out of like old papyrus paper.
Mm-hmm. It was. It was actually made from human skin over the... Uh-huh. From the 3rd century that I'd saved...
like they used to write books on old skin. Well, so then we're like, so
I go, hey, do you want us to take the sheet off? And I just kind of look at him, and he kind of looks at me like, there's a giant. It's not like a rip. That would be easy if it was just like a rip. It was like it was worn, Shawshank Redemption style.
Yeah.
What was that? Was it your restless leg syndrome?
No, that was actually just from cats that I'd previously owned that just burrowed their way in, and like when I would sleep, they would just run around inside the box springs.
Gotcha. Well, yeah. didn't you say you had a cat that would tell you when it was time for bed?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Actually, that was the last animal I liked.
Yeah? Out of any animal?
Yeah, out of any animal, that's the last one I liked.
Yeah.
The rest of them can kiss my ass.
Was it because the cat was kind of forceful, like, hey, bitch?
No, it was just, he was like a dog to most dog people.
Yeah.
He only came to me, he only sat on my lap, he didn't want shit to do with anybody else, he only wanted to be around me. That might be a metaphor for my love life. Like,
I'm pretty sure.
Because that was when I was engaged. That was back when I was engaged.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. That's a different weird. Time for a different story.
Yeah.
I do want to ask one thing. There are two stories, and then I'll let you go, and then we will put this out that everyone will enjoy. Two good stories.
By the way, where does this go? Like, who...
The cloud. No, it goes to the internet.
Like, do you have like a site? Is there a certain site you use, or
maybe?
I was just curious. I don't care. I was just
bestgore.com. I'm on there.
So I might read it later.
I'm gonna go hit a hammer into some Swedish dude's head for 20 minutes while this plays in the background. No, you had a few different jobs. And one I want to ask about...
Actually, I have a real issue right now.
With jobs?
No, I have to pee.
You have to pee?
Let's do this. Let's finish this job one real quick.
I'll pause it and we'll
come... No, let's do this job.
No, let's pause it and come back.
All right.
So we're back.
I felt good, by the way.
I bet it did. Basically, I wanted to talk to you about a few stories.
Okay.
Because you got a lot of them. You got some amazing ones that I just don't think you can come up with it. One thing I never knew. In your high school, you were an actor.
Mm-hmm. Best actor 2 years in a row.
Could you tell me what like your genre was? What you were known for?
It's comedy.
Comedy.
They were plays that were supposed to be funny. But you know, in high school, what they think is funny is not really funny.
Yeah.
So we ad-libbed a lot during play practice, and they liked enough of it that they just said, fucking just do that in the play. That's funny. I like that. So that's really what separated us from the other people, I guess. They read their lines, did their thing. We made shit up to make it funny. Yeah. So they liked that.
Yeah. One other thing, because you have some really good I never really had any good high school stories, and I don't think a lot of people had really good high school stories.
I think most people hate high school.
Yeah.
Every day I wish I was in high school.
Yeah.
I love it. I loved high school. I didn't care for junior high or elementary, but I loved high school.
Now, tell me about yearbook day. Yearbook day.
Senior year. What they do is they come around and they say, okay, French club, photos in the gym, 5 minutes. Spanish club, photos in the gym, five minutes, whatever. Me and my buddy, nobody's going to listen to this, so I'll say his name's Trent. We just decided to go to all of them. So anytime somebody came in and said, such and such club.
Chess club.
Yeah. Oh, it wouldn't, anything.
Anything.
Doesn't care. So we're in the yearbook and many photos just of clubs that we were not in. Well, no, we'd do it normal. We'd just be just smiling like we belong there. And no, even the people in the clubs didn't think anything of it. They're just like, oh, there's Chris and Trent being assholes again.
What if there were pictures of like the one they used was all just the whole class turning to look at you two and you're like, What?
I think by that time, 4 years in, I think everybody expected it. Like, they'd have been more shocked if we weren't in them.
Yeah.
They'd be looking around like, where's Chris and Trent? I don't understand why they're not here. Yeah. They're actually in class.
Yeah.
So, yeah, they just expected that out of us. And I think everybody at one point has that friend where you're associated with just them.
Yeah.
And mine was this buddy of mine named Trent.
Uh-huh.
And it was just,
wherever he was, I was.
Yeah.
It was actually a funny story. I don't know if I ever told you this one. He had money.
Hold on, real.
Exclusive. Dun, dun, dun.
Go ahead.
I used to borrow clothes from him all the time. Because my parents didn't give me money for clothes. And when my mom would, like, pick out clothes, they'd be so shitty I wouldn't wear them. And I'd have to fucking just throw them in the back of the closet. So whenever we'd go out cruising the belt, mm-hmm. I wanted to look good. He had a little way more fashion sense than I did. So I'd borrow his shirts.
Hold on, real quick. Mm-hmm. Can we go to the style?
Oh, back then?
Set us a year.
Back then it
was
Tommy Hilfiger.
Tommy Hilfiger.
Polo. You wear the polo shirts.
Oh,
Tommy.
Shit.
What was
playing on the radio? Can you give me a little bit what was playing on the radio? Give me atmosphere.
If we were in the car, it was probably Tribe Called Quest, Black Sheep.
Definitely you. When I think those, you know.
Early Snoop and Dre, we listen to a lot of that. Yeah, that's
Naughty
the time
by Nature.
Frame.
Naughty by Nature.
Mm-hmm.
I pick when I think of those bands, you pop in my head.
Yep, that was my Criss-cross. That was what we did.
You're a big Criss-cross,
man. You know, I remember Criss-cross. I don't think I never had like their CD
didn't
or
buy
anything.
That single.
And so even when I was back then, you know how I am with music now. Mm-hmm. I was that way then. I bought CDs every other fucking day.
Yeah,
but I never bought Criss-cross. Thank God. I can go to my
grave.
Was
Dangerous Minds in the theaters?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Anyways, so Trent borrowing clothes.
So I always borrowed clothes from him. And keep in mind, I'm at the time I was 5 foot five. He was 6 foot.
600.
But I never
pounds.
Gave him credit. Now, he was a skinny dude. He was a real skinny dude. Oh. I would never give him credit for that 6 foot. I always told him he was 5'11".
Well, you have to.
And he'd always say, I'm 6 foot. I'm like, no, you're fucking 5'11". You are not 6 foot. It was an ongoing battle we had. So anyway, I'd borrow clothes from him. So one day I borrowed a Tommy Hilfiger button up.
Ooh.
And I'd borrowed other clothes before. This wasn't nothing new. And before we were going out, I decided I need to take a shit.
Okay.
Okay. Uh-huh. So I go in the bathroom. I'm already ready. I've got my jeans on. I got my kicks.
Kicks?
My shirt that's not mine.
Your shirt and then a pullover.
Mm-hmm.
No, okay.
And then I go into the bathroom. I take my shit and then I go to wipe. Like I said, he's 6 feet tall. So when I go to reach back.
Oh,
the
no.
The sleeve falls down over my hand.
Oh, no.
And I wipe my ass with his shirt. And I totally went back because, you know, you check. And I'm like,
oh,
my
twice.
God.
No one ever gets one wipe.
I totally just wipe my ass with his shirt. So I pull my sleeve up. I finish wiping. Uh-huh. I take the shirt off. I go back into his room with it wadded up in a ball. Oh. And he's like, what are you doing? You don't want to wear that? And I was like, I wipe my ass with it.
I owe you $50.
He gave me the shirt. Like, he told me to keep the shirt.
There's not much else to do.
And I wore it for years after that. And he would ask me, he's like, is that the shirt you wiped your ass on? I'm like, yeah, same one.
It's a clear blue night.
Like I said, I didn't have a lot of nice clothes, so I washed the shit out and I kept wearing it.
Snoop Dogg. Snoop Dogg. And then yeah, bitches.
Yeah. So there was always the shirt
I
wore.
By the way,
that
shirt back then was an investment.
Mm-hmm.
Like, a Tommy Hilfiger shirt was like $50.
Oh, yeah. I didn't have $50.
No. Not at all.
No.
But, can you tell me, you guys had a flood up there, right?
Mm-hmm. Flood of 93.
The flood of 93.
Back in 93. I always like throwing the word ought in when I'm trying to sound old.
You were doing some work, right, up there?
We were working at a car dealership in Elwood.
Well, yeah. So you were, like,
it
were
was
you sandbagging?
The flood was in July, I believe. Uh-huh. It was hot as shit. This was probably August after the flood, after the water had kind of gone down. We're working installing phone lines. I honestly don't remember if it was a new building or if their building got destroyed and they were rebuilding. Mm-hmm. But either way, it was just the wooden frame.
We will rebuild.
Yes, rebuild.
Yeah.
They can't stop us. I don't even know what that is. I apologize.
It sounded like Nixon. Just the Nixon
I'm tape. Not a crook.
The next ones were just all we're doing is quoting the different Nixon tapes. Sorry, anyways.
So we're putting phone lines in this wooden frame. Mm-hmm. We're just drilling holes, running the cable, whatever. It's hot as shit. We happen to walk over
and sitting on a table are just 2 gallon jugs of water. Actually, no, it was 1 gallon. It was one gallon jug of water. We're thirsty. It's hot. There's water in a jug. It must be for drinking. So we decide to drink it.
Was it sealed?
No.
Nah.
No, it wasn't sealed.
Uh-huh.
So this was right before... Actually, I guess it would have been August, because school's probably started late August, early September. This is like... He ends up missing the first week of school.
Uh-huh.
I missed the second week. He got so sick, his mouth had blisters in it. He lost about 40 pounds. And this was a skinny dude.
Uh-huh.
So then I got it. Uh-huh. I got the chills so bad, so, I thought I was going to break my jaw.
Before that, so you drink this... this what is clearly safe drinking water,
which turns out to be flood water.
Flood water.
Mm-hmm.
When did you start not feeling all that great?
Actually, he got sick and I was fine, and I thought, "Oh, that sucks. We didn't it put sucks it together."
To be him.
Yeah, we didn't put it together. What that we an both asshole. Got it.
Yeah.
Until a buddy of mine, my other friend Jeremy, came over, and we were actually swimming in my pool. We were swimming, everything was going fine, and all of a sudden, I just didn't feel good. And I was like, dude, I got to get out. I don't feel right. So I got out. Within 10 minutes, I was laying on the floor in the fetal position with chills so bad that my jaw was hurting with a towel over me. And he came in and was like, holy shit, dude, what's going on? I was like, I just don't feel good. And I just stayed like that for probably an hour. I finally went to the doctor. Explained the story, and me and Trent had kind of talked and thought, kind of put it together that maybe that wasn't drinking water, because that's the only thing we could think of, because we both got the same thing right after each other.
And you hadn't been making out?
No, not that particular week.
Okay, this one?
No.
Or changing shirts and shit, so.
Yeah. No, so that had to be, I mean, that's pretty much what it was. It just stayed in our system for about a week. He missed the first week of school, I missed the second.
Jeez.
It was gone. But for all you kids out there listening to this horribly explicit podcast.
It's actually really explicit.
Don't drink flood water.
Flood water, bad. Okay, and then another great story that I like to kind of put together because I picture them happening in the same week is when you worked for the city, right? Mm-hmm. You don't have to say what city it was.
No, it's St. Joe. St. Joe's a shit box.
Shit box.
If anybody out there is thinking about going to St. Joe, turn the fuck around and go somewhere else.
Southside Rats?
Oh, yeah. You don't want to fuck with those Southside
Rats. It does... The city smells like poo when you get to... Well, just
do you go too far north or south, it smells like urine and shit.
So my boy takes me up there. He's like, man, let's go on a little road trip. We'll go up there and I'll show you some sights. I'm like, okay, it's going to take like 20 minutes to see everything. And he goes, you know, this is, oh, and so we're talking. He's like, oh, man, you know, there's some memories here. And he goes, oh, man, look at, there's this car wash place, man. That's where all the douchebags and assholes wash their car. And there was a line of douchebags and assholes.
Oh, yeah, they still to this day.
Washing their car. It was pretty funny. So I knew everything was pretty much spot on. But you ended up working for the city, right?
Yeah, that was actually my first job.
First job.
My mom got me that job. This is before when I worked with Trent, it was just usually in the summer and days off. It wasn't an official job. I just got paid cash by the day.
Well, duh. I wouldn't really expect you to be the most responsible type to be like, oh, let's get him to work.
So she got me a job, and she told me it was going to be weed eating and lawn maintenance and shit. So whatever. I did it. I think it was good money at the time. I think it was...
Better than
$7 an hour, which was good at the time.
Mm-hmm.
Hell, it might have been $5.50. Actually, it was $5.50 because minimum wage was $4.25.
Man, that's when you could get like a Big Mac for a dollar.
Yeah, yeah, $4.25 was minimum wage. I remember
now. You can still get a Big Mac for a dollar. Just saying.
I'm hungry.
Food.
Big Mac.
Actually, this story will not make you hungry.
Mm-mm. So the job turned into more than weed eating. It was cleaning abandoned properties.
Which I'm guessing there were a lot of.
There were many in St. Joe.
Uh-huh, I'm sure.
Once the weeds got to a certain level, the people would complain to the city and they would send us out. We did, for example, we did a house that the older lady that lived there opened up all the upstairs floors and let raccoons in.
Well.
And squirrels.
Where are they going to live?
And she put newspaper down. in the entire upstairs floor. We had to clean that. So it was nothing but squirrel shit and newspaper clippings. And
raccoon piss. Mm-hmm. I bet like you couldn't even get the papers up.
No, it was a foot deep. It was a foot deep in newspaper clippings.
Oh my God.
It was horrible. So one day we get called to a house that has the neighbors called to complaining about an odor. We didn't think anything of it. We figured, I mean, you don't think anything gross. You don't think like fucking body or some shit like that. You just think something stinks.
By the way, a body probably wouldn't be that big a deal.
No, yeah, back in when I lived in St. Joe, there was like zero violence. Like you'd never, like if there was a murder or something or a body, it'd be a huge deal. Now it's a little more commonplace because it's a shithole.
Mm-hmm.
So we go and we're checking out this house and we find in the basement a deep freeze. Big ass deep freeze.
Like a chest. Like
yeah, yeah. Like one of the kinds you like deer hunt and you store all the meat in and shit like that. And one of us, I don't remember who it was, cracked it open and immediately slams it down. It's full of meat. Just completely full of meat.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to get rid of it. Yeah. We have to lift it up. The smell was so bad, I ripped the sleeves off my shirt and I wrapped it around my mouth just to keep from smelling this somehow. Yeah. And literally, when we picked it up, there had to have been a million maggots underneath it.
Oh, my God.
It was disgusting. It was the most disgusting thing I've ever seen in my life. The clothes that I wore, I drove home. I remember throwing them. I just threw them straight in the trash. Like, you could not get that smell out.
Yeah. Did you, like,
gag? Thanks for that, Mom, by the way.
Did you gag all the way home? It was just weed eating.
Yeah, just weed eating. Just do a little lawn mowing and some weed eating. And
your mom doesn't sound like that, by the way.
I don't remember when she turned into Uncle Ben, by the way.
Uncle Ben. You used to have some great parties, right?
We had a few.
You know what? Speaking, since we're going the not so great things, tell me about the trailer and Little Caesar's Pizza. We'll end on that.
Actually, the trailer was a different thing.
What?
The trailer was down by Lake Contrary, which is where the ass odor in St. Joe comes from.
Okay.
We partied there a lot, but before that, actually, I can't remember if it was before or after. I think it was after. He lived on a house on Mitchell, and it was a shithole. I don't believe the bathroom had running water, if I'm not mistaken.
What?
Yeah, it was gross. Cockroaches. You just see cockroaches walking around the floor. That used to be where we'd order. You get $5 large pizzas at Little Caesars for Monday Night Football. That's what we did.
You still can. By the way, all the food stuff.
Can you really?
I'm just going to... Oh, yeah. And now they have... Dude, they have a Little Caesars. You know the deep dish? Mm-hmm. The ones that used to come in the sheet? They have bacon-wrapped ones now.
I feel like I want to watch football.
I feel like I could murder you and still eat one of those. You know what I mean? Like,
oh, absolutely.
You know what I mean? They sound delicious, but it's full of gluten and dairy. Anyways, continue.
So, I guess I can't really pinpoint one specific night. I know... There were many nights where...
Well, what about there was this, like a crawl space or a door and no stairs? Can you tell me about that at all?
Oh, that was that was actually the trailer. That was when...
So maybe all I'm thinking about is the trailer.
Yeah, that was the trailer. That was where my buddy Derek, who was our alcohol supplier before we were 21...
Yeah. Love that guy, man.
And one day we went over to visit him and we got there before he did and lived in a trailer and had a little set of metal stairs leading up to it.
Uh-huh.
So we thought it'd be a good idea. We hid the truck that we drove there, and we took his stairs and moved him behind his house. And we just peeked around the corner waiting for him to show up.
You guys just chuckled to each other?
Oh, yeah. We just chuckled and thought it was the funniest thing ever until he pulled up. He's like, you just see the look on his face like, what the fuck? I can't get into my house. And he immediately started looking around because he knew it was us.
When
he
you
just
explain
knew.
It, it's not, like, when you're explaining it, it's not funny, explaining it just now wasn't funny, but then in my head, I'm like, that is pretty funny.
When you kind of had to be there, and you kind of had to be like the guy that pulled up to your own house and can't get in because your steps are gone.
That's pretty funny.
Yeah, there's really...
I do like that. It just, but then I pictured like the furniture being made out of like Little Caesar's pizza boxes for some reason. Like there was, but that's all I pictured, like no running water and just... People just eating like, hey, what do you want? I don't know, Little Caesars. It's $5. Like,
well, the trailer was while we were still in school. What the fuck is your dog wearing?
We're not gonna talk about the Thunder shirt he wears.
Your dog.
By the way, if they had adult Thunder shirts, I'd be wearing one because it would help my anxiety.
What's a Thunder shirt?
A Thunder shirt is a compression shirt that helps them with anxiety.
Your dog has anxiety?
See, that's why I
Your
kept
him. Your dog has ARS?
He does. I was hoping to keep him in the other room so he wouldn't see that. Because don't worry. We talked about dog abuse for most of the podcast.
Is it because you beat him?
Yeah. Well, yeah. Or he came from a really bad home. He came from the St. Joe of dog homes. Actually, this is a perfect time to tell you that I bought you a Thunder shirt.
I'd wear it.
Would you?
No.
No. Well, okay.
I feel like, I don't know, for some reason I keep thinking Thundercats.
Thunder. Oh, yeah.
and I can't dress like a Thundercat.
Well, let me ask you that. What shows did you watch growing up?
Baseball.
Baseball? It's not really a show.
I watched...
Didn't you have a satellite dish, you said?
Mm-hmm. We watched... The only cartoon we watched growing up really was Looney Tunes.
Yeah. That's all. When it was like racist.
Was it?
Was it still the racism?
I don't remember.
Like they have the Chinese character. There was a Chinese character.
Oh, yeah, and probably.
Bugs Bunny would be like, oh, so sorry, sorry.
Yeah, probably. But we didn't really... I don't know. I feel like we didn't get to have like a kid phase. Like we watched that and then it went straight to Cosby Show and Night Court.
Cosby Show's kind of... Well, it's not really a kid thing, but it'd be like the same as like... Like Step by Step. Well,
yeah,
a black
so we went from
step.
Like Looney Tunes to Cosby Show to sitting in a room crying because my dad just threw something at us. So that was really...
Something heavy at you?
Yeah. Yeah, that was really it. I feel like there wasn't a childhood part.
No.
Yeah. So we grew up fast. You had to.
So you think that baseball is a sport?
It's the greatest sport.
The greatest sport ever?
It's America's pastime.
This is where it should stay, in the past.
I don't think he understands the word past time.
Okay, you know what? Maybe I would like it more if it didn't last 8 hours.
Well, they're trying to speed it up. They're trying to speed it up.
You pull,
hey,
an
NFL
cards?
Game takes 3.5 hours.
I didn't say that was great to watch either. But at least
Sports ball.
It would be great if they just, like, okay, in baseball, it would be great if they didn't let go of the bat. And you get one swing. So you may not swing at the first baseman. But you get one swing and you can keep it. So the third, so for a triple.
What if it's a ball?
What?
What if it's a ball?
What do you mean?
Like he throws it and it's 3 feet outside.
Well, yeah, if you hit, like, yeah, you get a hit. Let's say you get a hit, right? Mm-hmm. That's what it's called, right? When you hit the ball and it's not exactly caught by
right.
someone for an out.
Right.
Is that what it's called? An out? I know baseball. I'm just fucking with you. And I'm running to first. So instead of sliding and trying to avoid, I bring my bat with me.
Okay.
Hear me out. They get a helmet too.
Okay.
So it's not like anyone's really getting hurt.
So you want it to be more of a contact sport.
I would like that.
Okay.
I would. You know what? I'd watch it, and I think the viewership would go up. How do you feel about
that? I don't know about that. I think the people that watch baseball are... I guess a little more old-fashioned.
Yeah, like old.
Because like true baseball fans.
So okay,
don't like I'm not a big football fan because I think baseball is a pure. It's a more pure game.
Okay, so what's
football's
pure?
A blood
okay,
sport.
What's baseball other than boring to me?
Baseball is the thing about it. Baseball, you're in the batter's box. You have to hit a round ball with a round bat. In 0.7 seconds.
Done.
It's the okay. thing is, in baseball, if you succeed 3 out of 10 times, 3 out of 10, you're a Hall of Famer.
Shit, I could do that now. Okay.
I guess that's it.
So
you
everyone's
solved
a
it.
Hall of Famer.
Yep.
Whoopie-doo. Okay, maybe I just can't get past the peanuts. Like
it could
like
be. Maybe, yeah, maybe it's just your peanut allergy has completely obscured your view of baseball.
Or maybe that the other heterosexual male I lived with, whenever the Red Sox were on, we watch it. And guess who has the longest clock time of pitching?
That would be the old Red Sox. That would
be the Red Sox.
Josh Beckett was bad. He's gone. He's not there anymore. Clay Buchholz is still there.
Sweet Christ.
Playoff, you see, playoff baseball, even You watched Royals baseball in the playoffs. They were slow. Playoff baseball slows down. Playoff baseball slows down. There's more thinking involved. There's more strategy involved than people think. I mean, you think about...
I'm going to throw the ball fast.
You think about playoff baseball, though. It's not about throwing fast. It's about, if I'm going to throw it on the outside corner, I need my defenders positioned the opposite way if it's a left-handed hitter, because I want him to go the opposite way. There's a lot...
I'm listening. I'm actually listening. I'm trying to understand.
Oh, my God. I want to wrap this mic cord around my throat right now.
I think it's that you're trying to explain it to yourself and you're realizing you don't like baseball.
I love baseball. I think baseball is the greatest thing ever.
I love baseball.
Who's the best player of baseball ever?
Currently or ever?
Let's do currently and then ever.
Mike Trout. Currently.
Currently.
Mm-hmm.
What about the Randy Jackson?
He was a judge on American Idol.
the Rocker. John Rocker.
John Fuck Rocker you. Has not pitched in almost a decade.
But he hit a pigeon. He's the only person
that was Randy Johnson.
Bird. Right? The same white guy, right?
No.
No?
No.
He changed his name.
Don't and worry. Both of them don't pitch currently. Just so we're clear.
What about O.J. Simpson? Oh, wait, Bo Jackson. He played both?
Yeah.
How about that? Some say he's the greatest to play the game.
I don't think anybody says that. Well,
Bo Jackson's mom did.
Okay. I don't even think she did.
She was just like, nah,
yeah,
I don't
she's like,
so.
Ah, you were good, but I don't know about that.
Okay, so who's this Trout dude? What's this Trout
Mike
dude?
Trout plays for the Angels.
Yeah?
You know who Mike Trout is. Mike Trout.
The California Angels?
3 years he's been in the league. 3 years. He's finished in the MVP voting second, and then first.
So he only did first once.
That's because the guy that was ahead of him won the Triple Crown 1 year.
So?
That's hasn't been done in 30 years.
There we go. 2 seconds, don't make a first. Boom. Means your shit to me.
Yeah, he's the greatest player in the game.
Of ever?
Right now.
Okay, of ever.
Ted Williams.
Okay. But he was racist, wasn't he? He and Ted Cobb.
No, you're thinking of Ty Cobb. Ty Cobb was a huge racist.
Yeah. But Ted Williams. Oh, wait. He's frozen head dude.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, his sons are fucking insane, so they froze his head.
Yeah, and then there's like all these pictures of people like taking pictures of like Ted Williams' head with them.
Yeah.
Like with a tunic.
Yeah, his family's creepy, but Ted Williams was the greatest baseball player of all time.
He's not coming back, is he?
I don't think they're going to be able to figure that out.
If he does come back, can he re-enter the...
Oh, absolutely.
MLB?
Yeah.
Major League Baseball?
I don't think there's any rules against...
Who do you think will draft him?
The Red Sox.
The Red Sox?
Yeah, they had him before. They'll draft him again.
But do you think his contract still stays?
I don't think he'd play for $20,000 a year.
Oh, my God. What if you could get him still at that price? Like, you don't tell him that what money is now?
Yeah, because like, he just woke up, and he's like, that sounds like a lot of money. I'm in.
And just tell him that the only technology was to bring him back, and the rest, like, there's no internet or anything like that. How cool would that be?
Yeah,
like,
that'd be pretty sweet.
Yeah.
$20,000 a year for Ted Williams. That'd be good.
You know what? I would watch more baseball if Ted Williams would come back.
I'll get to work on that.
I would appreciate it. What about Babe Ruth?
What about him?
He got a candy bar named after him. That's pretty good.
Yeah, he's a fucking Yankee, so fuck him.
Oh, okay. So Yankees and Red Sox fans will never get along?
No.
So it's like the Bloods and the Crips.
Yeah, it's about as big a rivalry in sports as there is.
Really?
You know, I live KUMU every day, but KUMU is nothing like Red Sox Yankees.
Hmm.
It's just not. The only rivalry in baseball that's close would be Giants and Dodgers.
Yeah. Well, don't the Dodgers fans kill people?
Oh, they kill people all the time.
They do?
Yeah, mostly Giants fans.
They don't really. I think it would be rare to see a Dodgers fan kill a Dodgers fan.
I don't know. It's L.A.
Well, yeah.
I mean, they kill all kinds of people out there for fun.
Well, I mean, they also have the Raiders. So
yeah, nobody cares about the Raiders.
Well, no, but I mean, there's probably more exciting games going on in the parking lot.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
On the outside.
Raiders fans actually, L.A. fans in general are the worst fans in baseball or in any sport.
Any sport.
Yeah, they're known for showing up in the third inning and leaving in the seventh.
Really?
They're basically, I don't know if you've ever met Donyell. All L.A. fans are Donyell.
Really?
Yeah, they're only there to drink. They don't care about the game.
She'll be the first one to tell you this. She would totally
Shots.
Be a, she would totally be a Raiders fan if they were here, because she wouldn't have
alcoholic
to watch any of the
alcoholic gummy
game.
Bears. Those whores. Stupid. God, I need to. I do need to get DJ on this.
We do need to get her on a podcast.
Oh, well, we need to. Apparently, this is his podcast too.
Hey, I'm just Tubbs. I just talk when I'm told to talk.
Fatty and Tubbs talking about racism in sports, but mostly racism. Because I don't know much about. Like, I know sports, like real sports, like what men do, like men shit. But you know, not like this baby ass baseball. Like softball. That's equivalent of softball to me.
Who's what sport is Ronda Rousey playing?
Judo.
Oh, I thought she was.
It's an Olympic sport.
UFC,
is baseball an
UFC
Olympic
fighter.
Sport? Is baseball an Olympic sport?
Unfortunately, no.
See why?
Because the other countries are stupid.
The baseball committee, when they're like, "So guys, are you gonna let us in?" And they're like. You know, the UN of Olympic sports are like, no. And they're like, you guys are stupid.
You guys don't know what you're talking about, you fucking assholes.
Don't you see that I'm on the mound for 10 minutes before I throw a ball?
It'll be back. It'll be back.
It'll what?
It'll be back.
Now, yeah, Ronda Rousey is an amazing female athlete. She might be one of the best combat sports athletes ever. In a men's
sport.
No. It's a sport, but it's not a men's sport. Baseball's a men's sport.
Yeah.
You don't see women playing
hardball. I think MMA's been a men's sport for the most part until the last 10 years.
Uh-huh.
And I think women came along and changed that.
See, the thing is, I'm not as chauvinistic as you. I see it as a sport for everybody. You see it as, oh, it's got to be men, and then women have to have their own thing. Okay? That's chauvinistic.
I don't see Ronda Rousey pitching in the majors. No. I really don't even know where this is going.
I don't
right
know. Somehow we're just going to argue about.
Yeah.
Well,
Ronda Rousey's the badass.
She is.
That's what
she is.
That's what I'm really trying to say. Ronda Rousey's
well,
the badass.
Well, okay. So can I get on record? I would say film or on tape, which there are no anymore.
I hope you're not filming this.
It's being recorded.
I've been masturbating for the last.
I know, it's really hard to keep, especially about. And you just started about baseball. Just,
yeah. Oh yeah. Like, oh yeah. Fucking
3-2.
Bats. Oh.
Cutter.
Fuck.
You said you would never watch women's MMA.
I did. I did say that. I will be the first to admit when I'm wrong about something. I always said I would never watch women's MMA. I didn't think it was a sport. I think it was stupid.
Yeah. What would you have watched? Other, let's say women's MMA and then something else.
Probably like a crocodile eating a pig on like National Geographic.
Yeah.
Like just a boar wandered into the wrong river.
Professional bull riding?
No. Those are fucking hillbilly faggots.
Okay. Gotcha.
That's just dropped
6 beers.
I just
in
said that.
And
it's actually the first time
beers?
I've said that. That's actually pretty impressive.
You already said the N-word about 3 beers in. So 6 beers.
Yeah, but that was for Denzel.
Oh, that was for Zell.
That was for Zell. Zell's my nigga.
He would give you a pass.
Right. He'd be like, yeah, that's right. That's right. I am your nigga. I wouldn't say it in a racial way, but Zell knows what Zell is.
I want to have that. Zell knows. Zell give you a pass. By the way, I feel like I should, like, if I were to ever come back, I want to be Omar from The Wire. Minus the being, I mean, I guess I'd be okay with being gay if I was Omar. Because
did you watch
Omar's not,
you watched Boardwalk Empire, didn't you?
Yeah.
He was on there.
Chucky White.
Yeah.
I like him.
I just kind of started watching that.
Oh, you didn't like it.
I didn't the first few times, but
that's every show I've introduced you to. Sons of Anarchy.
No, I liked that from the beginning.
Did you?
I did.
I don't know about that.
From the first time I watched that show. In fact, the ending of Sons of Anarchy like still burns in me.
It burns in you?
A little today.
Like herpes. Oh.
Like, Sons of Anarchy introduced me to Ed Sheeran. I don't know if you've known my new fascination with Ed Sheeran.
I'm going down this road. Is he the guy who sings the theme song?
No, that's another guy.
The wind blows straight up your butthole.
No, he actually sang the main song from the second to last episode when Jax kills his mom.
I have it's not called Make finished. It Rain. I have not finished it yet. Spoiler! You have to say spoiler alert.
You haven't finished it. Oh no! Shit. Holy shit! I did not mean to do that.
Wow.
How far are you into
series it? Series ruined. Season 3.
Well, you still have to watch because you can see that coming when you start watching.
Yeah, I'm just messing
season
with
season 6.
I haven't finished it. I'm on the last season, but I haven't.
It's ridiculous. I watched the last season in 3 days.
But remember, okay, so there's that. That guy, I've seen those on your Facebook, and I can tell usually what mood you are in by what is posted.
Absolutely.
And sometimes I think about posting some tool on your page, but then I'm like, that's kind of gay. Mm. Like, hey, man, I thought you'd like to push it.
I actually pushed. Jesus Christ. Like I'm in a prison now.
Push your shit.
You ever had your shit pushed in? Actually played some tool the other day. On there.
Yeah.
And you know, I don't like to be too open with my posts, so that's why I guess I do it subtly with music.
Really? Really?
And only the people, but I do it that way because only the people that know me can tell what kind of mood I'm in.
Gotcha.
If you're just a casual friend of mine and I post some song by Shaman's Harvest about having a shotgun in your mouth,
yeah,
you're not going to know anything.
Well, yeah. But there's one song that is in Sons of Anarchy. And hard to believe, their club's getting attacked, and they're like, oh, they're getting ready, and they're locking down the hatches.
Oh, yeah.
And it's, who does that?
It's by Straylight Run.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a great, anyone should look that up.
I've actually tried to find, it's not on iTunes or Amazon.
I think it's on, I believe it's on my Rhapsody.
You might be able to find it on there. It's called Big Shot by Straylight Run. Unbelievable song.
It is, if you want a cool song, people, that's really one you should listen to. But so explain this.
They have a video for it too.
Mm-hmm.
He's in a, like basically an aquarium in a fish tank the entire time.
Big Shot?
If you want to see something cool, I'm straight up. I'm not being gay now that I'm in love with Ed Sheeran.
Billy Joel has a track called Big Shot.
That's probably not the same one.
You sure?
I posted this on Facebook the other day, and I doubt people watch it because nobody
watches. Hands in the sky.
Yeah.
In parentheses.
Big Shot.
Big Shot.
Yeah.
Okay, do parentheses.
I thought it was the other way around. I thought it was the other way around. So anyway.
You're not a fan. Fucking poser.
I'm actually not a fan. I don't like the. And I've listened to some of their other stuff. I'm not a big fan.
Gotcha. So continue.
So I know that 95% of the videos I post on Facebook, nobody watches.
Actually your highest reading on the meter yet.
Yes. Perfect.
Spoiler alert.
You need to look up Ed Sheeran, a song called Bloodstream, performed live at the Brit Awards. It's un-fucking believable. Things got really serious here all of a sudden.
Your tone.
You better check your tone, son.
Of your boyfriend's new song. Bloodstream.
I've actually been watching a lot of Ed Sheeran. He actually does.
Is he a British fellow?
He is a British fellow. I'm trying to think of what song. You probably heard him. I'm sure you've heard something by Ed Sheeran. I'm sure. What's the big song on the, like, not the big song, I guess, because I don't listen to the radio. But Thinking Out Loud. It's like a slow song, like a ballad. It's dumb. I don't like it. But the rest of his album is completely different. He actually raps 2 songs on his album.
Whoa.
It's pretty fucking wild.
Does he do something with Rob Thicke or...
No, Robin Thicke's a douchebag.
Okay. I mean, that's your opinion, but...
Raise your hand if you think Robin Thicke is not a douchebag.
It's a podcast no one can see and no one's raising their...
It's the same number that would be raising it if they were all here.
I'm just saying. So... Speaking of music, greatest band of all time. We'll finish with this.
You know the answer to that. It's Tool.
It's Tool.
Tool. Did you see the headline I posted on Facebook the other day?
I did see that.
Their lawsuit's supposedly settled. They're moving forward with their album.
Yeah.
It's pretty pumped
awesome.
About that.
Favorite album?
Probably Lateralis.
It's a good album.
Yep.
Well, okay, so let's just...
What's the best album you've heard in the last year?
Best album I've heard in the last year... That's really kind of hard because no one's really come out with a solid album. You know, Slipknot's new one's really good.
Slipknot's
I really like that.
Good.
I do like that one. Ed Money, the greatest hits, Eddie Money.
Is he being serious right now?
Maybe. I'm assuming not.
No, I'm fucking
okay.
You know, there just doesn't seem to be like I'm working on this album. It's like, no, I'm going to put two singles on a CD, and and then the rest is just filler. There's nothing that's like I like concept albums and stuff.
I'm actually kind of disappointed that you are not a bigger fan of Black Market by Rise Against.
I do like Rise Against. I really haven't heard their new album.
I love it. Every song. There's like really? Maybe three songs I don't care for.
Yeah.
The rest of them is bad.
Now, I did like their not this one, but the one before mm-hmm. with...
Make It Stop and Satellite. Had both of those on there.
What was the...
Help Was on the Way.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Those were really good. But you know what? We have shared a heterosexual awesome moment. And hetero, oh. Not homosexual.
Oh.
Hetero. The best one. So Tool, obviously the best concert we've ever been to. Mm-hmm. You've seen them twice, three times. I've seen them once. And it's not like no, you can't, because the thing is, they only tour every 10 years.
Yeah, at best.
At best, but we saw. People in Planes.
Mm-hmm.
If you have a chance, what's their one album? Beyond the Horizon.
Beyond the Horizon.
They
actually broke up.
I know.
Yeah,
but
there's no more People in Planes.
But we went there, and it was one of the most amazing shows I've ever been to.
I get on Wikipedia quite often to see where those guys are going.
Yeah.
So whenever he has a new band, I will definitely let you know.
It was a great show. Everything in no one got crazy, and then we did go see. It was Bless the Fall. Lots of emo kids in skinny jeans trying to mosh. It was Bless the Fall.
As I Lay Dying.
As I Lay Dying headlined.
Demon Hunter.
Demon Hunter was pretty cool.
Have you heard his new single?
No, is it good?
You should listen to Demon Hunter, I Will Fail You.
Really?
Yeah. It's something I listen to when I'm depressed.
No.
If you can believe that.
Okay,
yeah.
Well, let's do this. When you're feeling really depressed, I know the songs you listen to, but other people don't. And they might be like, I like that song too. Wasted.
Yeah, that used to be one of them.
It was
Stabbing Westward.
Stabbing Westward. A lot of Stabbing Westward.
Well, you know, interestingly enough, the Dreaming,
uh-huh.
His new band, they just released their first major label album.
Yeah.
Probably not 3 weeks ago. You should listen to a song called, what's it called?
I hope that's not the name of it.
Ah, shit. It's something like Just Another Breath Away or something like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, some gay emo shit.
Yeah, but it's like old Stabbing Westward.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, it is. That whole album sounds like Stabbing Westward.
Now, how about this concert we went to? We went to, it was at Voodoo.
Mm-hmm.
Smile Empty Soul. That was an amazing
show. Love
Smile
Empty Soul.
Those guys were awesome. We got to meet them after. And then Boom Boom Click Click Boom on there.
Saliva. They're done too. They broke up.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I'm pretty sure that guy ate the rest of the band members. I mean, we saw him and we were like, he was like, chop.
Click, fork, spoon.
What was your other one? It was broom. What was it?
It was stick, broom.
That's one of my favorite ones too. You can do so much with them.
You really can.
That was another good show.
Smile Empty Soul. They're one of the few bands you see with three band members.
Uh huh.
That's it.
And it's weird. And they're quiet.
Like I love Slipknot, but they got nine dudes.
They're all doing something different. They do have nine dudes.
Smile Empty Soul has three guys,
and then
they sound
they have
badass.
Nine dudes. And two drum sets, one still for the old...
One's just playing a big pair of empty beer kegs.
Like, Jimmy, go play... You see those oil drums? Fill them with fire.
You know what's funny about Slipknot? Mm-hmm. Their one of the guitar players, Jim Root.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you know who that is or not. He was actually a guitar player in Stone Sour.
Really?
He got kicked out of Stone Sour, but he still plays in Slipknot.
That's gotta be weird.
Here's a trivia question for you.
Oh, great.
What band came first? For Corey Taylor, Slipknot or Stone Sour?
Well, by the way you asked that, I'm going to say Stone Sour.
That's actually correct. He was...
if he gave me a third choice, I was fucked.
He was actually lead singer of Stone Sour, but he was a big fan of Slipknot and he used to go to all their shows, and something happened to their lead singer, and he auditioned and became the lead singer of Slipknot, and he released two albums with Slipknot, and then all of a sudden, he decided to go call his buddies from Stone Sour, and then they came out with theirs.
Do you think he, his audition was like... You know, when he was like, oh, it's awesome. And then, murdered, a goat while banging a chick. And they were like, you know what? I think you got the stuff.
I think so. I think he's pretty genuine. I think he means what he says. I think he slaughtered a goat.
Murder. Slaughter. Oh, dude. I'd watched a great documentary, and I think it's Burning the Palace. And it's about a Lamb of God and the guy, all the trouble they went through when the one guy was, accused of murder. Do you ever know about that? Mm-hmm. Dude, it's a really good documentary. There's some interesting stuff that happens in it, but you know, you look at these guys and you're like, dude, you put out some heavy stuff, but I'd hang out with you. You know, they're almost kind of almost band nerds. It's kind of cool.
I heard some bad news the other day. I don't know if you'll care about this or not. Chad Gray said that Mudvayne's probably never going to do another album.
What?
Yep.
I love LD50. Great.
One of the best albums of all time.
Dude, you put that on. And I don't care if there's a grandma and her grandchild behind me. If I'm in the mood, I'm closing my...
I'll elbow them right in the throat.
I'll break the window with my head, pull that old bitch out, and just beat the crap out of her.
Yeah, I'll hit her with a cattle prod, and I'll sing the fucking song to him. I don't care.
Yeah.
Oh, quit crying, you little faggot.
You know, and they'd be like, oh, you're next.
Was that too much? Was that too much? Not you. Lisa, you're not a faggot.
He's talking to someone
to my knowledge.
To the people here, it looked like he turned and said to someone else that they called him a faggot, but he was talking to the imaginary child sitting in the back. No, that is a great CD, but one of the cool things is you played that Mudvayne DVD, and it was really cool to see.
Oh, yeah, that's badass. I love James live Hetfield performances.
When he was jamming, these guys are good.
I love live performances. That's how you know a band is really good. Like, you can listen to a band, and you can hear them, and you think, yeah, that's a good band, but with the studio and all that shit, you don't really know.
Yeah.
Like, it might sound like Katy Perry lip-syncing or some shit when you hear them live. Mm-hmm. But when you hear a band live, if they're good live, that's how you know they're a good band.
Mm-hmm. Because I don't think we've ever been to a bad show. Mm-mm. That's like, wow, they are really produced.
But if you went to, I promise you, if you went to a Limp Bizkit show, they'd probably sound horrible.
I'd still go to a Limp Bizkit show. I'd still support them.
I would take a shit on your chest for Limp Bizkit.
How much would it cost for you to go see? This is the order.
Okay.
So the last band will be your feature. It will be Limp Bizkit.
Mm-hmm.
Kid Rock. Ball with the ball. We're not talking new country Kid Rock.
I almost put
Aaron Lewis in there.
Don't say that. Don't.
But country. Don't you, just country. New.
Don't you take his name in vain.
I apologize. That's why I didn't put him in there. So Limp Bizkit, Ball with, or Nookie Nookie, and all they're playing is...
They only have two. They're just playing the same two
and
songs
then it's
over.
Ball with the ball, Cowboy... Ball with the ball.
The Metallica remake.
Yeah.
Whatever that
That's
was.
That's so weird. I see that come on and I'm like, oh, here's Metallica.
And then you're Kid Rock and you're like, you fucking asshole.
American Bear. And then Nickelback.
Honestly, out of all those, I'd probably go to Nickelback.
Really?
Not because I think they're a metal band, but because I think...
Because they're your level. They're, you know...
I think if they played their early stuff, it wouldn't be as bad. But I think Kid Rock and Limp Bizkit's early stuff... sounded just as shitty as their newer stuff.
Okay.
At least Nickelback's early stuff wasn't gay.
Yeah. So, I'm gonna take that same thing, but we're going to put Tool at the end. Mm-hmm. But, after you get through Limp Bizkit, Kid Rock, Nickelback, Tool, but then, while Tool gets ready on a different stage... You have to listen to Limp Bizkit do Kid Rock songs, Kid Rock do Limp Bizkit songs, and then Nickelback do their songs plus Kid Rock. I mean, it's going to be, you're there all day.
It's.
It sounds like a fucking horrible day.
But
like
you get
a, like I got a request off of work and shit for this.
But Tool is playing unreleased.
I'd stay through no matter. I'd stay through fucking Toby Keith to hear Tool.
Toby Keith
play unreleased material.
Really?
Absolutely.
What if it was Tool featuring Toby Keith in all their songs?
I'd still have to do it. I'd still do it. That's how much I love Tool.
Blow shit. Come on my heels.
I'd still do it. Even if I knew ahead of time, I would sit through it until Tool came on.
Now, how do you feel about Pussifer, the side project? Now we're just getting into
it's getting better.
Talk.
It's getting better as it comes out.
Yeah. Now, I like Mila Jovovich in it. I kind of dig that the song off that last album that she's big into.
The only thing that confuses me about Pussifer is every album they come out with, they have like 8 remix albums. So I don't know the one to listen to.
Yeah, I agree.
But he's got a song called The River.
That's a great song.
That if you find the right version,
oh,
it's an unbelievable song.
It's an amazing song.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really good.
But you have to listen to like 8 versions to find the right one.
You do. But you have plenty of time on YouTube.
Right. When you have ARS, you have nothing but time.
When you have the ARS. They're just calling it the ARS podcast, the Alcohol Rage Syndrome podcast. But this is like, but guys that are guys and girls, hopefully girls, that you know, so it's not just
I like chicks.
Dudes in their 30s listen to this. That this is what King and I would do. King, when we lived together, I'd come over. King would be like, "Hey, have you heard this song?" And it's "My Life's Been Wasted," and he'd just look at me to the side and just go, "It's a great song." And I'm like, it's greatly depressing.
Oh, I've still got a whole list of those, brother.
And it only hurts now that there's like Amazon Prime Music and YouTube and all these bands. One that I really like now is that Woven War you were telling me about. I've been listening to that, and that's a mix of the lead singer of O Sleeper and what remains of.
As I lay dying.
Mm-hmm. Except, like, okay, real quick, Christian rock. There's some good Christian rock out there because the real good Christian rock is the ones that are not like, you know, our God is in us. You know, it's a little more ambiguous to like not exactly say God.
Mm-hmm.
But that dude for As I Lay Dying, that guy got jacked, man.
Yeah.
Did you see him? He got huge, and now he's blaming his recent
steroids.
Steroids. Yep.
And he also said, did you hear what he said about Christian rock?
Is it all fake?
He said that maybe 1 in 10 bands that they toured with were really a Christian rock band.
It's probably Red.
He said,
I picture Red.
Yeah,
being,
I can see Red
being the real one.
But he said they stayed. He said half the band members became atheists, and they kept doing Christian rock because it sold more records.
Well, yeah.
He flat out said that, so...
But that was is he coming back and saying that was
hysterical? No, this is while he was in prison.
Attempting to murder his wife through a hitman.
Yeah, this is later after he was in prison.
But what was his batting average?
Oh, he was a 270 here. He wasn't
270?
Bad.
He wasn't bad, you know, but he...
And you know, the thing is, the crime, attempting to murder your wife through an FBI agent...
Conspiracy.
Is that a crime?
I think so.
Like, you just thought about it, really. It's basically what it came to. Thought about it.
Well, there are...
You didn't do it. Maybe she was a bitch. You really don't know. Maybe, like, he came home one day and dinner wasn't ready. His shirt wasn't ironed.
Well, the shirt he was busting out of.
And then he went to dinner, and then the undercover FBI agent was like, fucking bullshit, your shirt wasn't ironed? Your fucking dinner wasn't ready?
Okay.
This is a
King's
total joke.
King's legal defense. King's legal defense is entrapment for the fact that his wife, she was a bitch.
And some other guy's like, you're fucking right, she was a bitch.
Man, I'd murder her if I were you.
Dude, you give me $1,000, I'll fucking kill her.
Kill her
and he's
right
like,
now.
All right, yeah, fucking kill that bitch. And then all of a sudden he's in jail.
Yeah. I mean,
because he had a bad day.
There are things you've said. Like, there are times that you've said things to me, and they never... when did your filter go away? Because there are things that, like...
About my sophomore year of high school? Yeah.
There are just things that would go, like, normal people don't say. They just don't say them. Because they run through that filter, they go, man, that's probably inappropriate.
Mm-hmm.
But that's why I love you, is because you don't. That filter doesn't exist, and I'm like, oh my god, that's amazing. That's how it should be said.
And it's all bullshit. You know, people that really know me know.
You mean
it.
You mean the things you say.
People know that I think it, but they know that I don't mean it. Like, of course, it's wrong to fucking hire somebody to kill your wife. But when you break it down to like everyday life, some days would you like to hire somebody to kill your wife? Fuck yeah, you would. But you're not gonna do it. That's the difference. You're not gonna do it. Lisa's here currently, but there's days I guarantee you she would pay somebody to kill her husband.
She doesn't have to really, but all she has to do is go to the store, $2.99, buy a whole big jar of Planters peanuts
and just dump them right in your mouth when you're sleeping.
That's all she has to do. Me, I gotta go find someone in St. Joe.
But see, that's what makes the difference between a good person and a bad person. A good person, every good person has those thoughts. I guarantee you Gandhi thought about fucking shanking a dude in his throat because he wouldn't give him a couple ribs.
He's just like, I would.
He's just like, he just really wanted a couple ribs, and the guy wouldn't give them to him.
Pork ribs?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, no, beef. They can't eat beef.
He wanted a pickled sausage. The guy wouldn't give it to him. He wanted to shank him in the throat, but he didn't. That doesn't make him a bad guy because he didn't actually do it.
Yeah.
So, Elisa, if you want to kill your husband, that's fine. It doesn't make you a bad person as long as you don't actually do it.
As long as you don't do it. It's right. Okay. How many people have you Everybody wanted to kill?
Oh, hundreds.
Anyone at this table?
Two. No. No, I'm just kidding. No. I would never do that to my friends. My friends mean the world.
I'm not going to lie. I thought about murdering you a few times.
I could imagine. I'm an asshole.
God. Just.
I could totally see that.
Like,
to
the point where I have someone go out.
Like, if you have a bulletin board in your room of, like, places I go with, like, little fucking thumbtacks in it.
I only have two. Your house.
And Best Buy's going to be the other one.
for Buffalo chicken logs. What is the best snack? What's the best snack at let's go with just QT's because they're the
most popular.
QT? They've added a lot now, man.
Chicken taquito.
They got pizza now.
Man,
they got
pizza. I haven't had the pizza yet.
Well, I mean, it's going to take you about 3 years, just like Sons of Anarchy,
right?
To come back around to it when you're like,
man. Did you know that pizza killed Quick Trip's mom?
Did it have thoughts?
Sons of Anarchy.
Oh,
same spoiler. Crow.
You see, dude, you got to say spoiler alert.
Same crow.
So explain a buffalo chicken log to me. Is it better than a taquito?
I don't even know what a buffalo chicken log is.
Is it better than a pickled sausage?
Better tasting or better physically?
Let's go with a better idea and then
It's a horrible idea.
Buffalo chicken log's horrible idea. Or...
There's never a time that
you're in the middle of a podcast. That's called dead air when you don't talk and I don't talk.
Oh, fuck. Pickled sausage is never a good idea.
Never.
It doesn't taste better. It's not a good idea. Nothing about it is good.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you enjoy shitting blood, which I don't mind. I'm not going to lie.
As it enters your mouth, you're like, ah, blood.
Yeah, instantly. Your intestines start bleeding.
So if you ever go to the doctor... And the doctor says, hey, is there anything wrong with you? You go, nah, I'm all good.
I'm good.
Have you ever done that?
I'm good.
Have you ever done that?
Yeah, I feel like I'm having a heart attack every day, but other than that, I'm good.
It's almost like they're begging you. Hey, you know, I kind of went to school for years and paid a lot of money to try to diagnose you. Nah, I'm good, bro.
Nah, you're Indians.
Don't be queer.
You see that?
The what?
It's a fucking Louis C.K. thing. It doesn't matter.
Yeah. Okay, final thing. I keep saying final thing. I love it, but I can't find a good
thing. Yeah, one more because I'm about to piss my pants again.
Oh, God, you and your baby butter. Best, funniest comedian?
Louis C.K.
Louis C.K.?
Hands down.
Hands down?
Hands down.
Well, just like the Red Sox and Louis C.K. and Sons of Anarchy, you're kind of jumping on the bandwagon, aren't you?
Kind of not a bandwagon. Sons of Anarchy is the best show of all time. It's a good show, but it's not the best show of all time.
Best show of all time?
The Wire.
Fucking great show. Favorite character off there?
McNulty.
McNulty. I like McNulty. You kind of are McNulty.
I am McNulty.
You are.
I am a little bit
McNulty. I just want...
I always pictured myself being equal parts McNulty, Dr. House, and the dude from Scrubs.
Zach Braff.
Zach Braff from Scrubs. Equal parts those three guys.
Couldn't stand that show.
I used to love it, but now I see it and it makes me want to vomit.
It's okay. I understand that. Don't touch it.
I'm touching it right now.
You're touching it.
Oh yeah.
You know what?
Oh, Consuela.
We'll
squirt for me, Consuela.
We'll leave on. Until next time, guys. Fatty and Tubbs, the ARS podcast.
Deuces.
Deuce.